last night.
That was
is,
Adam Rose, by the way. But yeah,
that was Adam Rose.
You got me fucked up here with the TV, buddy.
Yeah, well, what are you gonna do?
I need nut room. My nuts have got to breathe for 2 hours.
Yeah, well, what are you gonna do? Anyways. Speaking of 2 hours, we're going to be here for the next 2 hours.
At
we got
least.
Matt Boone off about a half an hour of sleep from last night. So hopefully I can wake you up and hopefully we can,
What does it look like?
We can get going here, you know, for the next 2 hours.
I'm sorry,
let's wake you up a little bit. People in the chat room, WZROnline.com/chat, WZROnline.com/chat.
Did we decide that this light off is better?
I like that.
I like it better.
I like that a little bit better.
Yeah.
WWE SmackDown's already been taped. They are over in the Europe countries. You're London for
the
London
Europe countries.
London for Raw last night. London again for SmackDown today.
Are they still in the O2 Arena?
O2 Arena for Raw and SmackDown. Normally, when they go to the UK,
they'll
tape
up.
Raw and SmackDown at the same arena. But when that happens, we get the spoilers for you guys in the United States. It's not a 5 hour delay.
They start about 3, they end about 5:30.
About 5:30, yeah, somewhere around there. So WWE main event SmackDown spoilers, which were taped earlier today, they are already up on the websites, WZROnline.com for that. Same thing with Raw yesterday. We had spoilers during the afternoon and then it aired here.
You're welcome.
In the United States. Thank
you. Oh, for the first half.
I had some errands. I had some errands that I had to do yesterday afternoon.
You had to be the good uncle.
Yeah, yeah. So you started spoilers for me, and I finished them up. But
no beer tonight, so no drinking game, for fuck's sake. Oh, there's plenty
of
beer.
Oh, there's
guys.
A lot of beer here. Maybe he doesn't have beer. Maybe that's what it is, right?
Beer's over here.
There's beer here, man.
This is just for hour one.
Always beer on Tuesday night.
We're already a few deep.
Right?
Yeah.
Jesus, man. How can we of course we got beer. It's Tuesday night. WZR TV, what are you talking about?
It's a night on Monday through Sunday. What are you talking about? Of course we've got beer.
So here's what we're going to do. We are going to run down Monday Night Raw from
last
night.
Where do you think these came from and those came from over there?
Yeah, the chocolate cheeks and the beer gut and everything.
The devil's cough medicine.
But, all right, so here's the deal. We're going to run down Monday Night Raw from last night. We're only going to do the high points and the low points because it was a tape show, and to be honest with you, it wasn't all that good last night. It wasn't
the crowd was
bad.
Fun, but because they a lot of the fun was stuff WWE didn't consider fun.
Right.
They edited a lot of the fun stuff out.
They edited crowd chants out too last night.
That's my point. They edited a lot of the fun crowd atmosphere, like chanting for this and doing this. You know, the main one I heard was the Cesaro thing.
Yeah,
was that, you know, obviously he's a Swish. Is that what we're calling him? Swiss? Is that what we're calling him?
Swiss.
Swedish.
Swish.
Swiss. Yeah,
Swiss.
Yeah, I said Swish on accident, but Vince doesn't know what to do with a Swiss superstar.
Right.
But either way, in a European market, you know, he's going to be... So apparently when they showed the graphic, for everybody who saw it, Cesaro faced Randy Orton on Raw. So when they first announced the match, they put the big graphic on the big screen. Supposedly Cesaro got this monster pop.
Huge pop,
when we saw it on TV, it was Randy Orton who got the
they
pop.
They got the pop, and Cesaro not so
Cesaro
kind
of got like a little... Yeah. It was basically, I'm just guessing this part, but basically whatever the pop was for Orton became Cesaro's pop on TV, and whatever the pop was for Cesaro became
kinda
Orton's
reversed
pop.
It. Let's
isolate this reaction for this picture when they show it,
right,
and vice versa.
Right. So we'll kind of do the high points and the low points of Monday Night Raw from last night. You're getting there.
I'm a professional.
You know what I mean? So we'll do the high points, the low points of Raw, and then this afternoon has just been so busy.
MMA wise too.
MMA too.
Yeah.
But
sorry to interrupt you. They got like a really cool video of obviously, Anderson Silva failed his drug test for his Nick Diaz fight in January, UFC 183. The current season of The Ultimate Fighter Brazil, they did a teaser preview video on their YouTube channel for the episode, which airs next Monday on UFC Fight Pass. But in the clip, it's like a 30-second teaser. they show that they, I guess they had cameras on Silva, because he was in the middle of filming. If you know the story, he was in the middle of filming. He was going to be one of the coaches. Shogun was going to be the other one for the Ultimate Fighter Brazil.
Right.
And then when Silva tested hot for popped hot for the drug test.
Right.
They took him off, replaced him with. Now I'm going to get it wrong. I want to say Little Nogueira, but yeah, I think it was.
But they had cameras panned on him when he got the.
Well, because he had to get removed from the show.
Right.
So
right.
When they removed him from the show, he's like, "What's going on?" Well, you failed your blah blah blah. He's like, "I didn't have anything in my system." Because it's subtitled.
Denied it right away. Right
yeah,
away.
All immediately. Yeah. He's standing there first finding out the news, so it's all caught on camera. And if you want to see that awesome piece of footage, MMAnews.com.
MMAnews.com. There you go. So a lot of stuff came out this afternoon. I guess we'll start with Bobby the Brain Heenan, who you guys have seen the photos of him in recent years. Suffered a stroke.
He's one of my heroes.
A couple of years ago, probably one of the best talkers ever in the history of pro wrestling. I mean,
we were talking about
top five, top three, maybe. Yeah.
Just the other day, we were talking about our favorite talkers. Yeah. And Heenan, I mentioned him. He was high on my list.
Got to be top five, man. I would say top five. I put Heenan.
We don't need to go through the list again,
because
we'll contradict ourselves.
I know.
People go back to the archive, but like just a week ago, they said a completely different list of names.
But anyway, Bobby Heenan underwent surgery today. Mean Gene Okerlund and Mike Tenay came out on Twitter and said that everything went well and all is good in Heenan.
That's
land.
What you're
so
saying.
That's
I'm
good news.
Telling you, I mean, you've seen the pictures of
it. I think you guys have all seen the photos.
It's going to be a sad day, and it won't be my prediction, and God forgive me for sounding gloom and downer.
It doesn't look good.
It doesn't. I think it's not going to be too long before we're going to have to write a very difficult article about a legend and a childhood hero of mine.
It's reality. He doesn't look great.
Second ever interview.
Was Heenan.
Sable was the first. Bobby Heenan was the second.
Right, right. It just, he doesn't look good with the photos. And then he's having surgeries here and there.
And he's such an upbeat, fun guy.
The last we had heard, and I think...
And he still is. I'm sorry. He still is, but he just...
There's a photo of him out there. He appeared at a convention not all that long ago.
Yeah.
Within the past year.
Those photos were terrifying.
He still had that sense of humor where you see him there, and he's flipping the camera off. You know what I mean?
And if you remember at the Hall of Fame, and this was 10 years ago.
Yeah.
One of the first when they really took it serious with the suits and stuff.
Right.
We
don't
have to rush too much. We're not doing.
No, we're fine. We're fine.
He had the throat cancer, so he could barely talk.
Yeah.
But his fucking razor sharp wit was still on point. He was still funny. He could still control a room with a
mic. Right.
He was the man.
And he was still flipping off the camera at that convention. So, and the last we heard, and I think it's still the case, is he can't talk. He can't communicate.
Barely.
So he's using a chalkboard.
Yeah.
So whenever he wants to say something, he's got to write it down. Hey, I want a bag of chips or something like that.
Yeah.
Hey, I want a bag of chips. He's got to write it on a chalkboard. To communicate with the people. It's really, really sad. But so we had that, and then just a couple of hours ago, Dean Mitchell, right? That's Dino UK.
Yes.
And Jorge, who's always great on Twitter.
George Romero, yeah.
Sent me photos and videos of three guys, three idiots, complete idiots, that at the WWE main event and SmackDown TV tapings today jumped the ring. What appears to be...
Was it only three or four? It looked like a lot of people in that ring.
I think it was four guys, because there was the one guy that gave his buddy the rock bottom, and then there were two other guys...
They were doing moves before security got... That's how great security was.
There were two other guys that were going like this on the other side of the ring, so I think it might have been four of them.
All right, well, the screenshot had the security in there, too. Plus, I think there was a couple of wrestlers in there as well, right?
You had John Cena and Daniel Bryan were in one corner,
it looked like a very full ring. That's...
I think it was right before the main event.
There's video of it, right?
Yeah.
I haven't seen the video. Where can people see the video?
I showed it to you a little bit ago.
Where can the people see the video?
They can go to WZR Online.
Set the guy up for a free plug here.
WZRonline.com. We've got the video. I think it's the second or third post down. But
shouldn't be hard to find.
You've got to see this video. It says must-see video right on it, because it's just so crazy. It starts out with one guy giving the rock bottom to his buddy. And it's like a Jamaican guy, you know.
Oh no, that was a South African guy. Remember when Orton got attacked last
year?
But
they got in the ring and they just they're hitting wrestling moves on each other. Right. And somebody said to me that last night at Raw, a guy, you know, when he went to leave his seat, he could barely get past security. Security was so tight last night. So the fact that this happened tonight
before the main event too, where they should be.
Yeah. Now, granted, you've got four guys that are all running into the ring at the same time. So you can get one or two of them, probably two of them, but the other guy, you know, you've got four of them at once. I can understand if it's one guy, you tackle him real quick, throw him out. Two guys, you got enough security, you tackle the two of them.
Forget
when you
security,
got four of them,
there's also an unwritten rule in the wrestling business. If a fan is in the ring,
right,
fair game. You can beat the shit out of them. Fair game. Because you don't know what they're coming in there for. They could have a knife. You could be in danger. Your job. Not your job, but as a wrestler, you pretty much have the freedom to, if a guy hits the ring, you fuck him up.
What goes...
Until security gets him.
I understand people have a
couple
beers. Real
quick, before I forget my thing, because you know my brain's not so good, because I've only had a couple minutes of sleep last night, but...
Right.
It's weird in the sense, and I had a different point, but I'll figure it out as I'm saying this, that the guys that hit the ring weren't looking like most crazy fans that hit the ring to go after a wrestler. They just wanted... I didn't see the video.
They wanted to have a mini match.
They wanted to, like, oh, we're going to have a little spot during the main event of our own with each other.
Right.
Did they even approach the wrestlers?
No. They were just in the ring doing their own thing. I'm going to hit a rock bottom on my buddy, and we're going to throw fake punches over here.
And then the last question is, roughly, because I know you haven't timed it, I know you got the video, but I'm sure you didn't pull out the stopwatch.
About 30 seconds is how long the video was, and that showed everything.
So how long would you say the time they hit the ring until the time they were cleared out, everything was finally back to normal? How long? Cause it seemed like they were in there for... I mean, usually when a guy hits the ring, even if it's two or three, it's boom, 3 seconds later, they're gone.
I'd say about 45 seconds, all in all. I mean, security immediately took two of the guys down right away, all right? They were down. And then the other guy who was Jamaican or South African and had a beanie on, he's the guy that came towards the camera and seemed like he made it over the rail, but there was a security guard that was kind of close behind following him. I guess they got all four of them and they were arrested, escorted from the arena.
Because I think you showed me the clip, or maybe you didn't. Maybe I saw the clip. Somehow I seem to have the memory in my head.
I showed you the clip.
I am way out of it. I'm in what I call zombie mode when I don't get any sleep. And I haven't had a lot of great sleep before last night, for the record. 3 hours, 4 hours a night.
Right.
But anyway, I'm just saying. That's why I'm a little disoriented.
But no,
I've already just forgot my point from that.
It's a case of four guys, four idiots.
Yeah.
Listen, I understand you have a couple of beers, right? And you do see...
I get the motivation and all that.
But I would never, no matter how shit-faced I am or how tanked I am at a WWE live event... I mean, fuck, Raw is coming to Albany, New York next week, and we're planning to go. I want to go.
I hope you take your nephew and...
Monday Night Raw next week, the Authority's coming back, Triple H, Stephanie McMahon, they're going to make a big, tough enough announcement. I'm guessing the host.
Yeah, and how many weeks until Extreme? I mean, that's not the go-home, but I think it's the second before the last.
But, one or two more
shows. So they're
going to
really start gearing up for the... You're going to get some good angles.
It's going to be here. So what you guys view next Monday and what we come on here on Tuesday and talk about is going to be from right here in Albany, New York.
There you go. So
we're thinking about going. Next Monday is also payday for me as well. So we're thinking about going to Raw next week on Monday night. So we'll see what happens, and I'll let you guys know on Facebook and Twitter. I'm sure Boone will as well. So before we get into it, speaking of Raw, we're going to get into Monday Night Raw from last night. Going to talk the news and rumors. Like I said, Bobby Heenan underwent surgery today. We had the fans, the idiots, jumping the barrier, the rail, the whatever you want to call it,
at the barricade,
at the SmackDown tapings today.
Also, it was a guardrail back in the day because it was a rail.
It was a rail.
Now it's like a padded barricade.
Yeah. The other big news, it's two TNA-related items. Number one, put it up over the weekend. There's been some pay issues within TNA.
Some?
And of course, when you put pay issues,
pretty
oh my god,
like
guys aren't being paid TNA, oh, they're going broke, and you immediately see these people come on with the comments and everything, oh, I told you TNA's broke, this, that. Here's the deal. TNA, the paychecks don't come out of Nashville, Tennessee, where they are headquartered. The paychecks come out of Texas, where Panda Energy
yes.
is headquartered. Panda Energy is in the process of moving corporate offices, corporate from one building to another.
Okay.
Panda Energy has a separate building for TNA, all right, for their paychecks, for their payroll,
yeah.
everything. So, due to the fact that they were moving offices, moving buildings.
That should not matter to the guys.
It shouldn't matter. And listen.
Yeah. And this is a bad example. But let's say Yard Barker was changing their location and your checks were 2-3 weeks late. Would you give a fuck what the reason
was?
No,
you've got to plan ahead for that.
Especially if you're beating your body up.
Absolutely.
You know, instead
absolutely.
Of typing. You'd be like, motherfucker.
So it turns out that normally.
And it wasn't just the wrestlers, I'm sorry. But it was also like the office guys. Are
right.
late on pay.
Normally, TNA paychecks are sent out on the first of the month, and the talent receives them around the fourth or the fifth of the month.
Okay.
When the fourth and fifth came around, nobody got a paycheck. Sixth, seventh, the eighth came around, nobody got a paycheck. At that point, you're thinking, wait a minute, we're 5 days, we're almost a week. We're almost a week into not receiving
It's not a
paychecks. No. So we're not receiving paychecks. So a couple of the guys went to the internet, went to PW Insider and said, hey, there's something up. Turns out that most guys got their paychecks on the 8th or the 9th. So they were only 4 days late, which, I mean, to a lot of people, if your paycheck's a day late, you live week to week. and... So, but they were 4 or 5 days late. TNA plans to make that up for the paychecks that are coming in the month of May. They're going to send the May paychecks early to everybody to make up for what just happened. So they knew it was a simple screw-up.
But this isn't the first time it's happened.
It's not the first time that it's happened. And I get that.
Not even recently. Like, a couple months ago, I seem to recall writing about a similar thing.
You're right. It's not the first time it's happened. It's absolutely
It's a bad
not.
Sign, especially in this one. I believe it was when they were still with Viacom, Spike TV.
Right.
And this was supposed to be the big saving grace, like money, that we cut live events.
Right.
We tape months and months in advance on a cheaper network that, you know, blah, blah, blah. And then we cut all the high cost, Hogan, Bischoff, Sting, like, you know, all those.
But it was just a case of their moving offices. And I get it. There's no excuse for that, man. Nobody should have to wait on their paycheck. I get that.
Well, then
man.
They should have been paid
that.
In advance before they
switched. Before they did the move.
Yes.
And that's, they're going to try to make up for it going into May, where payments are mailed out a little bit earlier. Now, speaking of TNA pay issues, this is the second story related to TNA. Taz and TNA, you got to hold your breath.
I know, but there's a new drinking game now every time I hiccup. I guess it's happened a lot. you got a good story? Because I'm going to hold my breath.
Hold your breath, man. I got this one. Taz and TNA. Taz was one of the guys that was not receiving his paychecks. He got pissed off and was supposed to be in Nashville last Thursday to do voiceover work. Basically, TNA tapes their television. The announcers aren't there. They then go to Nashville. They go into a TV studio. They watch Impact, and they do commentary while in Nashville. Not live in the arena, but while in Nashville. They watch it on the television, and they do the commentary there.
Did the noise here effect. Yeah,
Josh Matthews was there by himself and did the commentary single.
So
all by himself.
Talking shit about Jim Ross?
All by himself. He did it.
Man.
Taz didn't show up in Nashville last Thursday or Friday to do the voiceover work. He then went on Twitter and removed all mentions of TNA Wrestling, TNA Impact, took everything off Twitter, hadn't received.
And when was this? I'm sorry, you probably already said it.
This was last week. This was last week.
Beginning of the week, end of the week.
End of the week.
After the pay stuff?
This would have been right in the middle of the pay stuff, around the 8th or the 9th.
So, two questions real quick and then get back to the story.
Yep.
Do we know why he's pissed and doing all this? Is there, and if we don't, is there a speculation that's popular? Or, third question then, is there a speculation that you have as to why he...
No, I think he was pissed off, him and many others, that they didn't receive their paychecks.
But he's the only one really doing something
about
it.
Well, at that time, he still hadn't received his paycheck, and he said, listen, until I receive my check, I'm not showing up. I'm done. And at that time, late last week,
man,
he hadn't received his paycheck.
Yeah.
So he said, I haven't received my
not
paycheck
coming to
yet.
Work. Yeah.
I'm not coming to work. I'm not. And he didn't show up. So that's not to say. Now, let's say that Taz got his paycheck now, which I'm guessing has happened. As a lot of the guys.
And he could have a deal where if he doesn't get paid when he's supposed to, he
doesn't
have to.
He doesn't have to work.
You never know. I'm guessing.
But let's say now, all right, Taz has received his paycheck, all right, and he's got it. They can always come in, and Taz can fly in over the weekend, later this week, and they can redo. Josh Matthews was all by himself. They can easily redo that before it airs now that Taz has been paid. So it's not... It may be a big issue. I mean, it seemed like Taz was pretty pissed off and basically sent a message to TNA by taking this stuff off his Twitter account. Any plugs to Impact, I work for TNA. That was all gone.
Oh, he didn't send them a message. He made a point.
He made a point to take anything TNA related off his profile.
Okay. I thought you meant he like wrote them about something.
Right. So I'm guessing that that'll probably be smoothed over, unless it's more than just that. If he gets paid and there's still an issue, we don't know yet, but we'll see. That's a big deal for I mean, you need a commentary team for Impact. And
Tough Enough is coming back, and we know we can't have Hugh Moore, or what's it, Bill DeMott?
Bill DeMott, yeah.
I mean, obviously he's not going to be the host, but he was the original badass trainer guy.
What is
maybe.
I was going to say, what does that have to do with WWE? Yeah, there
you
go.
Now that's pure out of my ass speculation. I'm just
maybe
saying.
Triple H's big announcement next week is Taz coming back.
That's not a big announcement.
That'd be a shocker, though. That'd be a shocker.
It would be unexpected.
Taz,
but he's got a
anything.
Contract with TNA. Unless
that's
this is considered a breach,
a breach contract.
You don't pay me when you're supposed to. My contract's null and void. I can do whatever I want. You never know.
That's a good point, man.
I doubt it, but I'm just throwing that out there. But.
Imagine that. Taz
actually
comes out live next week, Albany, New York. What?
Yeah.
What does Taz do? He jumped ship from TNA.
And you're not going to go there.
Right.
You're going to be a bad
I'm going to be there, I said.
You're not going to take your
I said
nephew.
I'm going to be there.
You better
what
take
are you
that
talking
ball.
About? That's a...
he handled our pre-show.
I like
this
that,
week.
Man. But then you get contract issues, like you said,
yes.
Man. So it's probably not going to happen, but that's a pretty fucking good idea. You just had there for Taz to
well,
come
yeah,
back.
Well, I mean, because if
up.
You look at it this way, who's the badass trainer guy on the show? They need the hard ass, they need the nice guy, and then they need the woman.
Yeah.
So the woman could be Natalya, right?
Right, right.
The nice guy trainer could be, God, I couldn't even think, I'd have to sit down and look at the roster. The badass has got to be somebody that's not acting, maybe a Fit Finley, maybe a... Somebody that's a hard-ass son of a bitch that's supposed to really show them how the business works.
Right,
even
right,
though it doesn't
right.
work the way it used to, and you don't really need to do that bullshit anymore, but...
Alright, so anyways, here's the deal. How was the past week? The week was good. It's the same old work.
And window issues and all kinds
gotta
of
stuff.
Gotta
bring something up, man.
Is that where you're going?
God, yes. Okay. We had a problem with a neighbor. I don't want to get into it.
Oh, but we had a problem.
I had a problem.
The house had a problem.
I had a problem.
There you go. William Regal could be one of the trainers.
There you go. I had a problem of one of the neighbors texting my sister, all right?
Or the guy that took over for DeMott.
I had a problem.
A-Train.
Yeah.
I was just trying to wrap up that story. Now, you had a problem. Yeah, go ahead.
Had a problem with one of the neighbors texting my sister, all right? I sent him a text after I saw some text messages that had been on the phone that she was using. I saw some text messages. I sent the guy a text message, and I said, motherfucker, I should come over there right now and punch you in your fucking face. And I went off. I went off on the guy. The next thing I know, looking out the window, because my computer is right there in front of the window over in the other room there, right? guy comes storming across the parking lot, right? Comes up to my window and fucking smashes it. Glass fucking fly. Then he comes around to the front door.
Whoa, we'll run real quick.
Slamming on
add
the
to that.
Front door.
Your nephew.
Trying to break down the front door.
Favorite place to play?
Jacob's favorite place to play is right in front of that window.
He
thank
has the
God.
Window open with the trucks, and he likes to pretend like he's outside, but he
thank God he wasn't
too
there.
Too cold to go
so,
outside, so
of course,
he plays
you know,
there.
He goes away. He
thank,
goes away.
Thank God he wasn't there when it
he
happened.
Gets back.
Was the point.
And about an hour, 2 hours later, knock, knock, knock on the door, and it's a fucking cop, and she says, what's going on over here? So I went out there, and I explained, listen, I don't want to press any charges on this guy. I just want the motherfucker to lay off my sister.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? So
was this before or after he called you and kissed your ass, because he realized after he calmed down and
well,
said,
after
I'm going to get my ass kicked the fuck.
After the cop had came, gave me a call and said, you know, the cops are here, this, that, and the other thing, and I tried to smooth things over, but yeah, it was a drama week. Then, the other thing that happened to me over the weekend, and I know you don't like talking about it, but I got
to
bring it up real quick,
well,
and I'll make it very quick. On Sunday, I had to file my taxes, got those filed, and it's a lot of money that, poof, because advertising companies, they don't tax our money, so you gotta have some money aside, and, you know, you just gotta pay it
in.
I'm
not good at saving money, that's why I don't like to talk about it.
I owe five figures in taxes to the IRS.
And I don't make as much, so my problem isn't as bad, I suck at saving money, so. I don't like talking about it because it always, the little bit of saving I do have goes straight to it, and then I'm broke again. All that saving for nothing.
I'll tell you this, I had to write some massive checks on Sunday, that's all I'm going to say. Massive checks that damn near emptied my bank account, and now it's time to save back up. But anyways, alright, so here we go, let's get into it. We're going to talk Monday Night Raw from last night in our numero dos. We're going to be taking your live phone calls, we'll give out the phone number in just a little bit as we get into our numero dos. Also going to be taking your rapid fire questions, anything this week. We're going to spend a little bit of time on it this week as, you know, Raw was taped last night. We're going to do that quick this week and spend a little bit more time with you guys in rapid fire this week in our number two. The official home, the official website of WZR TV Tuesdays, WZRonline.com. We're on Facebook, Twitter, and YouTube as well. Facebook.com/WZR Army, YouTube.com/WZR Archive. We're on Twitter as well. All you got to do is go to WZRonline.com. Top navigation bar.
Is that it?
Social media tab. It's got a drop down menu. It's got all the links to Facebook, Twitter, and YouTube. WZRonline.com, the official home of WZR TV Tuesdays. Got a live chat room on and in progress tonight, as always. How can they get there?
I don't know.
They can go to www.wzronline.com/chat, wzronline.com/chat. Lots and lots of people in there, as always, tonight. Bada bing, bada boom. That's how it's done.
Oh, all right.
Here we go. Who do we have in the chat room tonight? Metal Matt 85, Dino UK, Robbie AKA Crazy Roller, A Train 001,
Carnelli. Robbie A. Crate, you already said that one. Dino UK,
Jared
already said
Hulk's
that one.
In there.
Ride Gals, of course, in there. Ron Jeet's in there. Nick D. Jericho, you're an Eagles fan. 0683. Decker.
Tasmaniac. Taz having issues with TNA.
Dark
man,
Angel.
You know.
Daniel 30DX. Anthony Remy. A lot of people.
All of them in there tonight. All right, let's
scroll down
to
for the rest. But we
Eagles fan.
And now a ton of people are coming in.
If we missed you guys, we'll get to you later. Let us know we missed you.
We're
and,
just getting warmed up, children.
We'll come back at you here in just a little bit. Monday Night Raw from last night, April 13th, April 20th.
Look, Seth Rollins sat in my computer chair for...
I kept saying to you... He sat in your computer?
Yeah, that's kind of like how I sit. What's
well,
up?
No, he's got the...
That was my kind in Florida.
Right.
Same exact one. And then that was the closest we had to it.
Right.
Same thing, black leather chair with the recliner. It's just a detachable footstool instead of a lever pull.
Seth Rollins, the laugh, dude, that...
I really missed a lot of Raw.
I
did very detailed coverage of the show, play-by-play, like I always do.
Yep.
But during the afternoon, because it was taped. Now, of course, I get paid the same for that as I do. I get paid per article.
Right.
So I got paid the same as if I was posting a two-sentence article.
Right.
For 3 hours of play-by-play, because technically it wasn't doing play-by-play of a live show.
Right.
So
right.
How that's any different to me, I have no fucking idea, but he did SmackDown today, so I guess it's all even there. Yeah.
WrestlePin 123, we didn't forget about you, brother.
Oh,
he said.
You have to scroll down,
said.
You missed a lot of guys.
Yeah, well, he said in the chat.
We'll do it at the end of the show
like we're supposed to.
So
yeah. I want to shout him out, you know what I mean? All right, so here we go. We opened it up.
You mentioned the O2 Arena, London, England.
Right? John Cena, his music hits, and God bless that UK crowd. John Cena sucks.
They got into the song again.
They did that whole routine, and Cena came out, and he basically said that, man, I love you guys in London. You guys are awesome. I'd love to see WrestleMania here someday. Now, I got to thinking to myself, man.
What a dumb thing for him to say.
WrestleMania in the UK. Listen, it's possible.
Very unlikely.
But would it air on tape delay in the United States, or would they do it live at 2 a.m.
so
everybody in England would have to go to Wembley Stadium or wherever it is, and the show would start at 2 a.m. European time.
So that we could watch it at normal time.
So that we could watch it at 8 o'clock. Or would they start it early at normal time at 8 o'clock in Europe.
The only
and then it would air on tape delay in the United States. I think they would make the 80,000 people or whoever in Wembley Stadium. They would if you want to see WrestleMania, you got to get here and the show starts at 2 a.m.
and they would do it
and it goes to 6 a.m.
and they would do it
because it's WrestleMania.
The production though is still insane for to do that in England and
to bring all that stuff
and just stream it all the way to America for international pay-per-view and the network. You keep forgetting about the network part of things. Technically they could do it live prime time in England, and alright, if you want to watch it everywhere else, you could stay up till 2 a.m. on the network, or you could watch it the next day because it's archived, but they don't want that. They want everybody watching WrestleMania live.
Yeah.
So it would have to be a situation, like you said, where they time it in England to where the English fans are kind of fucked so that everybody else is okay.
Right.
The last
precedent,
tried to do something like this was SummerSlam in Wembley Stadium. I believe it was 92.
Right.
Bret Hart, Davey Boy Smith, and another big match. But, It was a great show as far as a wrestling show.
Right.
And I could be very wrong on this, but maybe business was okay, but from what I remember, it was a fucking nightmare.
Yeah.
Production-wise, and because they were on traditional pay-per-view still, and they didn't have as much leverage, it was a nightmare across the board. To finish my thing.
Yeah.
When they would do pay-per-views in England, they were called Insurrection, Resurrection. Do you remember what I'm talking about?
Yeah, I don't.
Those British-only pay-per-views, Insurrection, Resurrection.
I remember In Your House, but that was America.
Yeah,
that was
In Your House was everywhere. But they would do a annual pay-per-view in London. Please, somebody in the chat, help me out. I want to say Insurrection, maybe Resurrection, something like that. But they would do those at a time that was convenient for the local UK audience, and then you would pretty much if you wanted to watch it in the United States or North America or whatever,
it would air on tape delay.
Insurrection, okay.
Insurrection.
I was right.
All right.
Says Rygal. I didn't say I was right.
He
said I was right. But then you would, if we would become basically the UK fans. If you want to watch it, you can watch it on a replay at your normal time, and that's about the best we got. But they would never really do anything.
Now, they're saying Rebellion.
And Rebellion. Early on, it was Insurrection, and then it became Rebellion.
Rebellion. All right, no doubt. I think if they were ever to do WrestleMania in London, it's 80 to 100,000 people. Those people are going to have to show up at 2 a.m. because their main market in the United States is going to want to watch it live. And if it airs on tape delay, I don't think it's a good idea. WrestlePin in the chat room says, Boone, you're always fucking right. You see him over here? Hey, look at this. look at this comment, right? Get out of
like
here.
You're not quick to point some shit out when you're right or I'm an asshole.
I'm always right, man. But, I'm always right. You know
yeah, I think there was talk not too long ago, I seem to recall, that they want to try and do SummerSlam again in England.
See, SummerSlam, I would do. I just don't think they would take a risk with WrestleMania. Maybe.
Well,
maybe,
the thing with
anytime soon, that's
WrestleMania is the big one.
Right.
SummerSlam, I guess, would be a big one too, because like everything about pay-per-views now is not how many pay-per-views can we sell.
Yeah.
It's how many people can we convince because of this pay-per-view to sign up for the network.
Right. Yeah. Yeah.
SummerSlam would be one of the big ones where you would try and get people to lure them into the network.
Mm-hmm.
Whereas WrestleMania is the goal that we would not have made WrestleMania a $9.99 same as every other show.
Right.
Price for included with the network, unless it was like our big fucking lure to hook people to sign up.
Right.
SummerSlam would probably be the second biggest one of those. Some would debate Royal Rumble.
Rumble would be.
But SummerSlam's supposed to be the WrestleMania of the summer. They like to do it in Hollywood, but I think they broke tradition and they did it in New York.
They're coming back. Last year they did it at the Staples Center in, but they're coming back to New York.
New Jersey.
Yeah,
this year.
Yeah.
They were going to
do
the Meadowlands, or the Izod Center.
Barclays or Izod?
It was going to be the Izod Center, but I'm still stuck on the Meadowlands from way back in the day.
They closed down.
Izod Center closed down, so now they're doing it, I believe the Barclays Center.
I believe it's the Barclays Center. So anyways, getting back to last night's Monday Night Raw, John Cena comes out, talks about having WrestleMania, possibly in London.
You really have to handle this. I didn't even come in there to dick around and watch Raw with you and Jake.
Well, Cena's basically out here to open Raw, and
I heard you marking out. The chance must have been...
No, I was marking out because Jacob's out there playing in the dirt, and I kept saying, John Cena, he's on.
I thought I heard you singing the John Cena sucks thing.
It was John Cena sucks. I went along with it
a
little bit.
And there was a cool chant for Bad News Barrett that I heard you doing.
They loved Barrett. I can't remember what they were chanting at Barrett.
It was a good one, because I heard it on a radio show. I'm reading the notes here that you've got. He did the Bang Bang McFoley thing, but they never announced it or acknowledged it on announcing.
Right. Well, the fact that Barrett came out, John Cena was out there cutting his promo and announced that, listen, my U.S. Open Open Challenge continues, or U.S.
Yeah.
Open Challenge. The U.S. Open's a golf tournament. The U.S. title Open Challenge continues tonight. Who's in the back? Who wants to come out? Step up. I'm here. I got the U.S. title. Let's do it. That brought out Wade Barrett, who, of course, being in England, you get a massive pop. You always get a massive pop. You get one for, like, Fandango. You get one for Barrett. You get one for Regal when he comes out, right? You get, who cares about the damn chance?
Yeah, I guess it was just thank you, Barrett.
So
a lot of things I don't care about with you either, motherfucker. Calm down. So, you were in the middle of a speech.
So he comes out. So we've got John Cena against Bad News Barrett for the U.S. title. Of course, John Cena wound up retaining here. By the way,
is the match any good?
A lot of short matches.
Short matches. I don't know what goal there was, because anybody that knows anything about European, UK wrestling fans, whatever you call them, I get it all confused all the time. Are they British, England, UK, Europe? What the fuck do you call them?
Right.
But, no offense to our many UK fans, but, they love good wrestling matches. They don't all need to be Iron Man 60-minute time limit, you know, Broadways or
but
whatever.
But give them a good amount of time.
But give them a fucking 10-minute. You got 3 hours, for Christ's sake.
Right,
you know?
Right. So, Barrett, I mean, they did the false finish where they got the UK crowd hobby.
I think it was because they wanted to squeeze a lot of the UK kind of talent in the matches, like Bad News Barrett, Cesaro, Paige,
Fandango,
Sheamus. I could go on once we get down the list, but Fandango's not British. But
he's not British, but he gets over the people that get over.
You're right. He's like an adopted British guy. They
right,
love that.
Right.
Thing. Adam Rose. There, it was a bunch of them.
People like that. They did the false. Who?
Adam Rose.
Yeah, he's got the accent. He's something.
He might be not Australian, but they say he's Australian because he sounds Australian. I don't know.
No, he's definitely got a solid accent. I mean, that's not
But Australian and England sounds exactly the same people who don't know any better.
So they did the false finish where Barrett hit the bull hammer and went for the cover. He kicked out. He kicked out. Like Jacob.
Oh,
Jacob's
yeah.
awesome with that, isn't he? He kicks out.
He takes the
out.
Best flatbacks of any 2-year-old I've
awesome,
ever seen.
Man. He
fearless.
Sells. He sells. Like, we'll take a pillow, right? And I'll hit him with the pillow.
Yeah.
It'll fall back. It'll
like
do the arm movements.
Like a redwood tree being knocked down. It's just...
Yeah. And then he'll roll around and be like, oh. And it'll
fearless.
He'll groan. He'll go, oh.
Yeah.
Oh. Oh.
You know, you give him a fake, you give him a work punch, and you go,
right, right,
and he will, oh, oh,
he sells
oh,
it,
and then he'll just,
awesome,
boom, fall down,
he awesome. He's 2-year-old. He knows
he's
what
he's got
doing.
A future in the business.
He knows
if
what
you
he's
start
doing.
Training him and taking him serious with this stuff, right. As much as he loves it, as much as he has a natural instinct for
right.
the physicality of it, and he loves the showmanship of it.
Right,
that little son of a bitch.
He's gonna be. Yeah. He's gonna be a wrestler. We don't have like. We gotta start doing the super kick. You know when somebody hits a super kick, right?
Smack
you get the super
leg.
Kick and they slap the leg, and that's where you hear that fucking.
Yeah.
It sounds like.
Especially
it's
if they don't have any pants on, or if they have spandex or leather and something. And
Shawn Michaels when he
gives a good
it,
open hand
that
palm
bam.
One. Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. Every time because they slap the leg, but you're so focused on the kick going to the face.
Well,
you don't
like
see the leg slap.
When
that,
they do the stops on the ground, you know how those work.
Right, 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 right.
You stop the left foot while you're pretending to kick with the right. That
yep.
way, because the way
the
canvas is made, when you stomp your foot, it...
Yeah. Yeah. Right, right.
Like, that's what it sounds like. Let me kick you right now and see what sound it makes.
He's
it won't
tough,
be that sound.
He is a tough guy, man. Yeah, little Jacob's tough.
He is a. He
dude,
can take
man.
A licking and keep on ticking.
He's awesome. All right.
Bad
choice
of words for a 2-year-old, but yeah.
Yeah. Well. Anyways,
that match
so
went about 10 minutes.
It went about 10 minutes. That was a decent.
So
time,
and it
right?
was the opening, right? There was no big promo to start the show.
Yes, Cena cut the promo and basically said, "I want WrestleMania."
It was a quick one.
At some point. It was a very quick one.
Yeah. So they didn't
and
do the long.
That the main reason I'm here is to my U.S. title
open challenge.
Open challenges.
Yeah. Well, my point was, they use every week. It's a 20-minute promo segment to open the show.
It was a quick one.
And they did a quick, let's all right, quick. And then boom, 10-minute match.
Well,
so.
They did the match, and then after the match, they went back into promo mode, where
yeah.
Lana came out. Lana got a huge pop, by the way, last night on
She's
Raw,
getting
man.
Over like a baby face.
She's good.
Big time.
And they're big. Vince is high on her, too.
Yeah.
So we put that up on the website. But
she's probably doing some favors for him.
So,
That's a joke.
Yeah.
Don't sue us. If
she's doing favors to Rusev,
if,
who came
if
out
you
now.
Do sue us, my name is Ryan Clark. Contact me day or night.
So Rusev comes up behind Lana. Lana's on the microphone cutting this promo, right? And he comes up, and they talk about their match at Extreme Rules. And it's revealed here that they're going to face each other, and it's going to be a Russian chain match.
Yes.
All right, a Russian chain match at Extreme Rules. By the way, they announced.
Do we know what that is?
Yeah,
where they tie it around the throat, or around the wrist. Or
I would have to go back and get the description that we put up today. But WWE.com put up a little blurb today that showed the definition of a Russian chain.
Is it the
match
one where you're gonna drag them around and each you have to touch each corner?
In the chat room, if you guys have that little blurb that we put up on the website today, let us know in the chat room wzronline.com.
I'm thinking of the dog collar match Piper and Valentine had at the first Starrcade.
God, we've got
that was beautiful.
You know what
but
they announced?
The traditional ones, you wear them on the wrist. And you gotta hurt your opponent so bad that you can drag his unconscious body until you slap each corner,
turnbuckle,
and when
right.
you get to the fourth one, that's how you win.
That's how you win, right. You know what they announced today at the SmackDown tapings? It's Sheamus against Ziggler.
I wasn't listening, I was trying to see if they had the rules. What? Sheamus Ziggler?
I think it's. Is it Sheamus and Ziggler in the chat room? Yeah, it's Sheamus and Ziggler. And the stipulation for the match is a kiss my arse.
Arse?
Match.
Because Sheamus is
Sheamus, arse. Now, what I'm thinking, and you're going to call me crazy. You're going to call me crazy for this. But, right? When I see Dolph Ziggler, who is a guy in WWE from years ago, Who does Dolph Ziggler remind you of?
There's a couple.
A little
guys.
Bit. Who?
Well, I mean, there's Billy Gunn.
Now that's where I'm going.
There's
but okay.
Mr. Perfect.
Mr. Perfect.
Little Shawn Michaels in there.
Little Shawn Michaels.
And there's one more that I'm not thinking of.
I'm talking about his work with style. The blonde hair, though.
Oh,
like,
you're
I'm
just
talking
look. At the look.
I'm talking look.
Oh, Mr. Perfect and Billy Gunn coming.
And Billy
mind.
Gunn.
Yeah.
So I'm thinking, all right, Billy Gunn, the Ass Man. He had that whole gimmick, and then you got Ziggler out there. And I just feel like somebody in creative, some dumb 25-year-old, got this idea.
Oh, and, Mr. Ass and Arson.
Mr. Ass and Arson. You put them all together, and then at Extreme Rules, we have a Kiss My Arse match because it's Sheamus, and you know how he's
is
always
is that official for Extreme Rules?
It's, they announced it at the SmackDown tapings.
Okay. Spoiler.
So, somebody's kissing somebody's ass, and it's got to be Ziggler kissing Sheamus's white ass.
Ziggler,
so
yeah, he's the heel. Yeah.
When Sheamus pulls down his pants and it's a... And they're probably going to have Sheamus go in tan or something like that. So when he pulls down his pants, it's like he's got the tan line where it's nothing but a white ass. And then Ziggler, who poor fucking Ziggler, dude. The guy's got all the potential in the world. But you know that he's losing this match. And you know that they're going to humiliate him. And you're going to have Dolph Ziggler, a guy who's got so much fucking potential.
Or he doesn't kiss his arse and he, like, low blows him and leaves and...
Yeah.
That keeps the program going.
I don't...
The stakes with the stipulation in the next match. Get out of it.
I don't know what it is. I don't think they want to get out of it. I don't know what it is.
Yeah.
I think Vince doesn't see something in Dolph Ziggler. Never has.
He's been getting used pretty good lately.
He's been getting used good, but he hasn't... There's never been...
But it looks like they're taking somebody who's being used pretty good, feeding him to this new Sheamus that they want to get over as the super heel. So who better than somebody everybody loves being forced to kiss his ass, you know?
I think...
Now Vince got heat to kiss my ass club.
I think Vince has, I mean...
Among other things.
I've seen Dolph Ziggler on the microphone, whether it be in backstage on the Fallout videos or where on the JBL and Cole show. The dude is awesome on the mic. We know he's a really good in-ring worker, right? I just think Vince doesn't like Ziggler for some reason. And I think...
Address that.
I think they're gonna embarrass him at Extreme Rules, and I don't know why they continue to do it. But Vince doesn't like Ziggler. Address Parnelli.
Parnelli in the chat room. We said we're supposed to be more interactive with the guys.
All right.
On the planet. He says you can't show booty on a PG show. Basically, how are they going to show him kissing his ass? A.
It's a pay per view.
Yeah, it's a on the network, which they can put whatever rating they want there. I mean, you got to sign up for that. So.
They added Attitude Era stuff on the network today.
They've got all kinds of crazy shit on there. Yeah, but
That's
A. And B, he doesn't have to pull his pants down, you know.
No.
C, I really don't see it happening. I really see it as the beginning of something that goes somewhere else afterwards. Because you got to remember, Extreme Rules, pretty much every match has to have, not every match, but looks so far, it looks like every match has an extreme stipulation.
Except
we'll
for the
get
Divas
into,
match. That's
we'll get
the
into
one,
the world,
right?
They can still add one. The world title stipulations we'll save. We'll get into those later. Mm-hmm. You already said the Russian chain match.
Right.
There's another one that's not coming to mind. We'll
kiss
get in,
my arse. Yeah,
we'll get into it as we go
right.
through.
All right.
Yeah,
all right.
I think it's like their version of what's a TNA pay-per-view that has gimmick matches in every match. Oh, that's
Lockdown
right.
with
oh,
the.
Oh, that's right.
The
every single fucking pay-per-view they do. Jesus Christ.
They've got the Lockdown, which is, I mean, that's all cage matches.
I
mean,
I thought that was called something else. Lockdown.
No, Lockdown's the all cage match
Six
pay-per-view.
Steel. So, all right, I guess
they've got the Ultimate X. Destination X is all.
But basically, if you look at any TNA pay-per-view lineup, even the one night only ones, I mean, it's always gimmick match, gimmick match, gimmick
right.
match.
Bound
Nobody
for glory.
Care unless
Bound
we
for
give
glory.
Some crazy gimmick and not realizing
right.
you devalue the hell out of gimmick matches. If every match has a gimmick,
right.
then the gimmick doesn't mean anything. It's
right.
supposed to be a special thing. Like, oh shit.
Right.
This won't just be a regular match, folks. Something different's going to happen in this one.
Right.
It's not different if it happens every fucking show.
Yeah. All right, get to our live chat room, WZROnline.com/chat, WZROnline.com/chat. Get in there. Lots and lots of people in there, as always, tonight. Michael Cole was back on Raw this week, by the way.
Should have switched those out for Cole before we started.
Yeah,
he was back. He wasn't wearing the neck brace. It didn't seem to be selling the fact that he was hurt at all.
He did subtly mention that he was going to sue Brock Lesnar. So
dumb fucking thing.
See where they go from here, though. If they do a long, drawn-out angle with Michael
Cole. Lesnar would have to be around for a lot of that.
That's true.
Or Heyman, and where the fuck's Heyman been? You know.
Well, they could have Paul Heyman represent Brock Lesnar in his lawsuit against Michael Cole.
I guess,
like that.
But that would be kind of wasting TV time on something that, where's the payoff?
True. They had Triple H plug an announcement next week live in Albany, New York. Albany, New York.
Yeah.
We're in it. We're here.
Close to it. So,
Hey. Somebody got hit by a train.
I thought that's where you were going. You
know, right down here, man. Yesterday, pretty much right outside our window. I mean, hear the train go by.
There. Where we go to get cigarettes.
Right there.
It's a block down the road.
About a block down the road. Yeah. There's train tracks. We always hear the train and the honking go by. Yesterday, a guy got hit by the train. 35-year-old guy.
I mean, list the injuries. It was bad.
He's got head trauma, a broken back, a broken neck, head trauma, and everything else.
And some other douchebag got arrested for...
And then the cop came up, and while the news cameras were recording...
It's like a very modest version
they
of
the showed
Rodney
the cop
King.
Fucking stomp on his... on it, and
he's handcuffed with his hands behind his back, sitting on the track, and you see the cop kick him in the back and stomp on his hands. So it's kind of like a... very mini version of the Rodney King thing, where it's because it's caught on tape, you can see it.
Yeah,
it's on tape. Police brutality.
I will say this.
There's no such thing as deserving it.
Over the last couple of weeks, if you guys go to CNN or any of these websites, there have been a lot of incidents of
with
police
abusing
their
somebody
power.
Somebody just showed me a.
I don't want to get into a whole thing, but I will say this: there are. Some good cops out there. There really are. There are some good cops out there. So, for people to come out and when they see videos like this, listen, the videos that I've seen in recent weeks, they're fucking brutal. One guy got taken off a horse in the middle of the desert and they just clubbed the shit out of him.
What was the one
like 40 times?
North Carolina? Do you know about this one?
The one in North Carolina. I've heard
about it. My buddy Michael Moody posted a video and it was pretty brutal, like almost Rodney King level from what I remember.
That was last week.
It was very recent.
Maybe
it was NorCal.
The videos that I have seen, they're brutal, and those cops should be in jail themselves. But there are good cops too, and you never see the videos. Like there was a video I saw just the other day in Ohio. A state trooper pulled over. A woman had a flat tire. The state trooper jacked up the car, put the spare tire on, and changed it for her, and sent her on her way. It was a black cop, it was a white woman, sent her on her way. But you know what?
Yeah.
You don't see that on the news.
That's not news.
You don't see that on CNN.com.
It's not news.
It's not news, but
Ladies and gentlemen, a cop helped a woman change the tire today.
All right, but you always see the negative stuff on the news, the bad cops on the news, because that's what sells. I get it. That's what sells. But
if the headline on your newspaper, your local newspaper says, cop helps girl change car, you're saying, I'm not buying that paper.
But
now, if the headline says cop kicks the shit out of someone in handcuffs, let me buy that one and see what's going on.
But then there's other ways you can, I mean, listen, all these guys that are getting beat up or clubbed, they're running. They're running from the cops. They're running away.
Yeah.
The guy's jetting from his car. He's taking off. They're running for some reason. And then it leads to something. If you comply and you just do... I'm not saying all the time, but most of the time, if you comply with the cop, he'll let you on your way, may write you a ticket, but go on your way. Instead, a lot of people are running. You can go both ways, but I'm just saying, there are good cops out there, and
absolutely,
there are cops that follow the rules, but there are bad cops out there, too.
And
so
that's why I was
it
happy
goes both ways.
That's what I was happy to say when you said, there's a lot of people don't think there's good cops, there's a lot of good cops. I agree with you. There is a lot of good cops. My personal experiences with the law, the police authorities, and I've lived in about 7 states, about 40 cities in my life.
Right.
I have never really had a pleasant experience.
But you've probably always been shit-faced or whatnot, and you're back-talking the cop.
Absolutely.
And then if you back-talk the cop's got every reason to back-talk you back.
Absolutely, but there's a way of going too far with it. I mean, come on.
I know.
How many times does a cop have to deal with a drunk guy? Especially if I'm in my own home.
But think about how much cops have to go through on a daily basis with various... it's a tough job. It's a tough fucking job,
sometimes,
man. It's a tough job. But anyway...
You hear about the glory stuff. 90% of the cops dead sitting around in a car.
I get it. And people...
You're not wearing a seatbelt.
People in the chat room saying, you know, the guy that, you know, thought that he was using a taser and instead he fired a shot into the guy and the guy wound up dying. No excuse for that. But, you know, listen... This would be a whole nother show if
Am
we wanted to get into
criminal?
It. Average criminal?
Stephen Grabeck. Boone is an average criminal.
No. I don't know.
You got me all
right. Paige won the Divas Battle Royal that they hyped up.
They kept that short.
And then after it was over, Naomi, or this was later in the night.
No, it was right here.
Or it was right here.
She attacked her and then later in the night pretended to apologize. And
she's going to be off TV.
Bullshit.
Her and The Miz are going to be, I think it's The Miz.
The Miz and Paige.
Are going to be off TV. They're going to be filming. WWE.com put up an injury.
That's the name of the movie.
Right. An injury storyline today. Just saying. Put up an injury storyline today, so it looks like she's going to be out for a couple weeks. By the way, Jey Uso, speaking of WWE.com, underwent shoulder surgery today. This guy worked WrestleMania events before WrestleMania, after WrestleMania on Raw. Finally wound up getting shoulder surgery last week.
Did he work after or Mania?
Got the surgery last week. Hasn't been on the UK tour. WWE posted a video.
Yeah.
It was only Jimmy Uso and not Jay. Who's been working the house shows
singles matches?
Right. He's going to be out 6 months with Jay.
Is it a rotator cuff? Do we know any details?
Oh, man. It's an elaborate. We put it up on the website today. It's like a four word type injury where it's like an elevated interior. Like something.
Something that has an initial.
It's
like
quite the injury.
Deltoid or something.
Something like that. But it dealt with his shoulder, and he's going to be out 6 months.
So that's just a testament to how much of a trooper he is to work through it.
Or he went WrestleMania. He went Raw after. The Raw's after WrestleMania. Yeah.
Did he work matches on those Raws? I don't seem to recall that.
There were tag team matches, so the workload may not have been...
I don't
recall
that. Maybe, I'm not calling you wrong, I'm sure there were, but I just remember specifically WrestleMania, the kickoff show, the very beginning of the match, they got him out of the ring and had him lay there, like, hurt for pretty much the whole match.
The Ascension, dude. Burial continues.
Another
on
quick
Raw.
Match.
The Ascension was supposed to be this big dudes coming in.
You've
got the
forever.
Lucha
Dragons
out there. Two tiny guys in
but their offense is believable, especially Kalisto.
I think Kalisto,
I don't know about the Lucha Dragons, I think eventually Kalisto splits off and they say, let's try and make him our new Rey Mysterio.
I wouldn't doubt it.
I really think so.
They hired the guy to, he's part of the NXT rookie class. They brought him in, he worked a dark match. Without the mask. He worked a dark match a week or two ago, but they didn't have the mask on him. But, I can't remember the name, man.
Name with the mask?
That's what I'm trying to think of.
Oh, not Kalisto.
I can't remember the name.
Wears a mask in NXT?
Not an NXT guy, brought him in from the outside. Brought him in from Mexico.
Oh, okay.
Brought a guy in to do a dark match. Didn't have the mask on, so you wouldn't have known if you were at the SmackDown. No, it was somebody, it's like a three-word name or something like that.
Okay.
I'm a big fan of the Lucha Dragons, though, on Raw. I like the high-flying stuff. I like the crazy acrobatics,
you know what I mean?
The
old ECW shit
like
mixed with the Ring of Honor shit,
So once again, the Ascension buried again on Raw. Another quick match, like you said, two minutes. Roman Reigns comes out to a mixed reaction. Booker T's in the ring to interview him.
Yes.
I thought Reigns was pretty good last night, man, on Raw.
I missed
it. Just basically promised the fans that...
I know it happened, but I missed it.
Going into his match with, or going into his match with Brock Lesnar, he promised that it was going to be a brutal match. And
it was.
Booker, it was. Yeah. It was. Booker T asked him about the Suplex City thing from Brock Lesnar. And
Jan's Suplex City, like a motherfucker, drowning him out. I don't know if that aired on TV, but I know that was the report I got.
Big Show pops up on the Titantron, and you've got Reigns up there saying, dude, Show, you're nothing more than Rollins's bitch or some giant bitch or something like that. So, looks like they're going to set up something between Roman Reigns and Big Show.
Are you going to skip the whole thing? Big Show came out and chokeslammed him through the cab.
I'm getting there.
I thought you were...
He was on the Titantron at first.
Okay.
He was on...
But he came right back out. You just hit the button, man.
What happened? I didn't... Oh, it was this.
Yeah, good job.
This came out. Well, fuck. What time is it?
We've got 9:03. We can go a break.
9:03, so we got to go to a commercial break. Anyways, I got to get my
wallet.
I got to get my...
Not going to work.
It doesn't work. Yeah. Anyways, so we're going to reboot this computer. We got to go to break anyways. I was going to leave off there, and we were going to take a commercial break.
How do you do the numbers lock button? Where's that
at? I don't know. But anyways, we're going to take a commercial break. We'll come back on the flip side. We're going to be taking your live phone calls. Jackie, we want to hear from Jackie. So your live phone calls, if you guys want to call us up after, you only got 2 seconds. If you guys want to call us up after the commercial break, you can do so. The live phone number to call is 518-712-3070. 518-712-3070.
Phone lines won't be on until we're back.
Though. Until we're back. Yeah, so if you call now, it's not going to work.
Wait till you see us again and then start calling.
We're also going to do rapid fire. I'm going to put that up during the commercial break. Submit your questions, comments, whatever you guys want to talk about. Rapid fire. Tell them how they can submit rapid fire questions.
Pretty basic, man. Take a sip of beer. I'll be done. You go to facebook.com/RyanClarkWZR. That's facebook.com/RyanClarkWZR. Once you get there, the top post will ask you for your questions and comments for the rapid fire segment here on WZR TV and our number 2. We will answer as many as we can, usually all of them in a rapid style fashion.
Keep them one line.
We'll try and keep them brief so we don't have to spend most of our time reading. Facebook.com/RyanClarkWZR.
RyanClarkWZR. All right. So, on the flip side, when we come back, our numero dos.
Like what did we leave off talking about?
Anybody, we were talking about Roman Reigns and The Big Show.
I don't have either one of them.
You don't have either one of them.
I gotta get some new music.
All right, we are. We're gonna come back on the flip side. I'll get the Monday Night Raw report back up. But we're gonna come back, like we said, your live phone calls and whatever else you guys want to talk about. You are listening to WZR TV Tuesdays with Matt Boone.
Me.
And Ryan Clark.
Him.
I got the Raw report back up.
All right.
We come back from the break. I'm talking to you guys. Finish up Monday Night Raw. Live phone calls. Rapid fire. WZROnline.com/chat. WZROnline.com/chat. You're listening to WZR TV Tuesdays with Matt Boone and Ryan Clark. We'll be back, chat, right after this.
Yes.
We'll hold off on SmackDown because we never
do. Is there any, like, significant something that happened that we should cover?
No, nothing big. I mean, it was your regular SmackDown broadcast. I don't have the spoiler report up anyway.
I didn't know if there was any news that came out of the show, like, oh, we should talk about that.
Just stipulations for Extreme Rules. That's Allison coming home here.
Okay.
But, yeah, nothing significant. Just your normal, you know, Thursday night SmackDown episode that normally airs. So, we'll finish up Monday Night Raw. We've got the rapid fire up. If you guys want to submit rapid fire questions,
tell me when to turn the lines on. I'm sorry.
Okay, facebook.com/RyanClarkWZR. We'll open up the phone lines here in just a couple of minutes once we get through Raw. We'll do the just kind of the
at least half the show, right?
At least half of it, right? We had past that. Randy Orton defeated Cesaro. You talked about this earlier with the crowd reactions.
Technically did, yeah. Oh, with the editing. Yeah, that was when they were announcing the match.
Right.
During the match, it was Randy Orton versus Cesaro, but Tyson Kidd and Natalya came out with Cesaro. Long story short, Orton gets DQ'd because of some interference by Kidd. Kane then decides to make it a handicap match that's immediately being restarted right now.
Right.
But there was a stipulation. It was that it's now a handicap match with Cesaro and Kidd against Orton. And if Orton wins, he gets to pick a stipulation for his WWE World Heavyweight Championship.
Boy, Kane had a rough night last night, right?
He's teasing a babyface turn.
I saw that last night,
It's a big swerve like Seth Rollins that 1 week that nobody saw coming. But at least that was the story of the night. I mean, right. I always wonder, too, how when somebody's pretending to turn heel or turn babyface, and they beat the living shit out of their partner.
Right.
And then when they never turn, we got you. Like, wait a minute, didn't you beat the living fuck out of that guy the other week?
Right.
Like,
why isn't he pissed off at you?
Yeah,
you know what I mean?
We got you. My nose is broken, and I'm in a sling for the next 3 weeks. But we fooled you.
Right. We had
led to the handicap match, which I'm trying to recall real quick here.
It was Rollins, Kane, and J&J Security, right? Or they were watching from backstage, from the backstage area.
Okay.
I don't know where it is. Kane objected to the idea. It was Kane. We're talking about...
No, this is the Orton Cesaro. This right here is the handicap. So what happened right here?
All
right.
Earlier in the night, remember when Kane set up a match? It was going to be Randy Orton versus Kane. They did it backstage, and Randy Orton basically told Kane, "You're gonna lay down for me," or
Seth Rollins.
Seth Rollins tells Kane.
That's a whole different thing, though, to what we're talking about.
Is this what I'm talking about?
Yes.
All right.
I believe so.
There's a backstage segment.
Okay, so Orton wins by DQ. Over Cesaro because of interference, blah, 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 blah. Kane immediately restarts the match, but now it's a handicap match. If Orton wins, he gets to pick his stipulation. Oh, that was it. If Orton wins, he gets to pick the stipulation for his title match against Seth Rollins at Extreme Rules.
Right.
If Orton loses, he's no longer the number one contender and doesn't get the title match against Rollins at Extreme Rules.
And we already know that it was going to be no RKO allowed. So Seth Rollins has already picked that stipulation. There's no RKO allowed in the match. So Randy Orton, at the end of Raw, picked the stipulation that it's going to be a steel cage match. So in addition to Seth Rollins gets no RKO in the match, Randy Orton gets
backstage, like you said. Rollins, Kane, and J&J Security were watching Orton win the handicap match, which means he gets to pick a stipulation. Kane then told Rollins, who was there, if he beats Dolph Ziggler, who was originally scheduled to fight on Raw, it was going to be Rollins and Ziggler, that he and Orton will both get to pick their own stipulation. He gets to pick one if he wins, you get to pick one if you win. Long story short, the matches get shuffled up, and it becomes Rollins versus Kane. And
Rollins wants Kane to just lay down.
Yes.
Take the pin.
And that was during a backstage.
We'll get it over.
Yeah. Your job as Pride Authority is to protect me and this title and make sure that I,
So when that happens later in the night, we'll skip ahead here, but when that happens later in the night, that's Allison. That's Allison.
Okay.
When that happens later in the night, right, Kane acts like he's going to lay down.
It's Big Show. It was Daniel Bryan approaching Kane.
Right.
Backstage. And Daniel Bryan's basically like, basically paraphrasing, where's your balls? Why don't you be a man? Have a little pride, a little self-respect.
Go out there and face him.
Go out there and beat his ass.
Face him one-on-one.
Be his little bitch, basically.
Right.
And you see Kane kind of, and I compared it, any Breaking Bad fans will know, it's that old Mexican who ding, ding, rings the bell in the wheelchair because he can't talk.
Right.
Anytime he's upset, he's
like, yeah, dude. He makes that real mean face.
And he's breathing like that. Yeah. So anyways, Kane's doing that while Brian's doing all that talking to him. And then long story short.
So when they get to the match.
Well, the matches get changed. It becomes, it's important. The matches get changed. It's now going to be Kane versus Seth Rollins, and Ziggler is going to be fighting Neville,
right?
Which we find out later. But all right, so now it's Kane and Rollins. Rollins is basically trying to convince Kane and thinks he succeeded in having him just lay down, get it over with, so he can pick a stipulation too to match Orton's stipulation, which we don't even know what they are yet. We're going to find those out later in the show.
Towards the end.
So I guess we can skip ahead. We get to the Seth Rollins versus Kane match after Daniel Bryan convinces Kane not to be a bitch. We get to the match. Kane comes out in the suit, doesn't look like he's ready for battle at all.
Right.
And long story short, Seth Rollins orders him to lay down. Let me pin you. Let's get this over with. And after some stalling, Kane does lay down. Rollins covers him. 1, 2. Oh, he kicks out.
Oh, he kicks out.
Jacob would have been perfect for that line.
He would have been great.
He says it great. But, all right, so he kicks out. He gets up. Rollins is shocked. J&J security hit the ring. Kane clears him. Kane then... just fast-forwarding through nonsense and stalling. Kane chokeslams Rollins. Does the signal for the tombstone, but halfway through stops.
Stops. Second thoughts.
Yes. And then basically, well, no, he chokes, and then, yeah, he laid down and grabbed Rollins' arm, put it on him. 1, 2, 3. Rollins wins.
Three.
Kane gets up and leaves.
It was basically...
so now, further speculations...
it was basically Kane was saying, dude, I could have beat the fuck out of you. Yeah, well, that stone pile drive you, but
obvious.
I didn't.
Yeah.
I cut off a little bit, and I let you pin me. You got what you wanted.
Yes.
But I still beat your ass a little bit.
Storyline-wise, right. Though, yeah, and it should... basically, the storyline point is Kane is defying the authority, still...
teasing a babyface turn, like you said.
Exactly. Or the big swerve that it looks like he's teasing it, and he's really not going to. When,
right.
When somebody thinks they can count on Kane because he's been doing this shit,
then,
when they rely on him because it looks like they can count on him, he fucks them.
Right,
oh,
right.
Fuck.
But then that goes
point
back.
Being, though, after all that, Orton gets to pick a stipulation, and Rollins, because he beat Kane, they each get to
right.
pick a stipulation.
Right.
And then you can.
Well, it goes back to your point earlier, though. All right, if it's a big swerve and Kane is just not going to turn babyface
yeah.
and he's going to stay a heel,
pretending.
Then why did he beat Rollins' ass for a couple of minutes during that match?
From a storyline perspective,
from a story
to throw people off, so nobody
right.
expects it.
I get that, but like you brought up a couple of minutes ago,
why is he still beating the fuck out of someone?
Why is he still
yeah.
beating the shit out of him if he's not going
to
do it?
That's
right,
the stuff
you know?
That never made sense to me.
It never makes
when they do the swerves,
doesn't make any sense.
When they do the swerves where a heel beats the shit out of a heel,
right.
and then later helps him, and, we got you, we were playing you all along, but like, wait a minute, didn't you fucking say, put your mouth on the curb, Rollins,
right,
and
right.
stomp his face in, like,
right.
We got you, we only broke 7 of his teeth.
But it doesn't make sense,
no.
storyline-wise, right.
Not long
had,
picture, long-term, big picture.
Damian Sandow defeated The Miz, right? I mean, this...
we have the exact time for this match, too, by the way.
This feud, going into it, right, the crowd is all on Damian Sandow. They love him,
yes.
right? They love him. And then you think,
all right. Sandow, and it takes a while.
We're going into WrestleMania. We're going into WrestleMania, bro. You can do a match. Crowd is cheering the fuck out of Damian Sandow. They're booing The Miz. You have a big storyline. You have a big feud. And all of a sudden... they do it on Raw. Oh, here's
and
a match
why
on
is
Raw.
Summer Rae
here's,
part of it now?
Here's a, and then Summer Rae gets involved.
Why? Because she's doing a movie with
Damian,
The Miz.
This
or she
would've
did
been,
the Marine with The Miz.
This would have been Damian Sandow if they wanted him to be a breakout type guy. This I think would have been
though.
The feud. They don't, and it's
no.
the same thing with Dolph Ziggler, where Dolph Ziggler, in my opinion, at Extreme Rules, and you say they may go a different route, and you know Ziggler low blows him or do something like that,
what?
So he doesn't have to kiss his ass.
Oh, yeah, yeah. That
at Extreme
thing.
Rules, maybe
yeah,
they
yeah,
go
yeah.
some other route where there's
low,
a low blow.
Yeah,
something.
They,
well, that's
they
what
just ultimately
you mentioned
they don't get
as,
to it.
As an example
yeah.
earlier, you said maybe Ziggler low blows him or something like that, so he doesn't have to kiss his ass.
Okay.
Which
I don't remember saying low blow, but that, the basic gist is, yeah, they don't do the kiss-ass part.
Right.
However they,
don't
they
do
get
the
there, right?
I think that you know, Vince is, it's the same thing with Damian Sandow, and it's the same thing with Dolph Ziggler, where Vince just doesn't see something in either of those guys. So I think at Extreme Rules, I think Dolph Ziggler's going to be forced to get Sheamus' ass, and I think Vince and whoever else
yeah.
backstage is going to be backstage giggling, you know,
well,
like,
you were,
we
yeah.
made Ziggler kiss his ass. It's the same thing with Damian Sandow. They had him out there
see
in this
that?
Spandex
yeah.
fucking suit the one week. The you
basketball
know, pants,
jerseys.
Right,
he was the parody guy.
He gets
week.
Chopped out, but look how much the crowd was cheering him.
But the big thing there is, A, I don't see how that relates to anything about Ziggler and the not kissing the ass thing. My thing is that Sandow is over right now because he's a goofball comedy character. He got over for doing the stunt double, the rolling around, being a total jerk off.
Right.
He cannot get to the next level doing that same shit. A, he's got no fodder for comedy to do that stuff anymore. Past the point of once he's done with The Miz. Like, once The Miz and him are done and their program's over, and Sandow's moving on to bigger and better things, is he going to be as over when he's not doing that goofy comedy shit to defy The Miz?
He's not going to have a chance. He's not going to have a chance.
It depends on what they give him. And whatever they give him, is it going to be connecting with the audience the way the goofy comedy shit was?
Well, what's he got now? He's got Summer Rae by his side.
That I don't understand at all. And other than the fact that Summer and Miz did the Marine Corps, that's the only connection I can see, which WWE fans don't even fucking know about that for the most part.
Right.
They do storylines on Total Divas and completely contradict themselves on Raw. So, like, I don't see how they think there's this big synergy to where if you watch Raw, you also watch all of the shitty WWE Studios movies. You also watch all our dumb reality shows on E! For women. Not every fan watches all that. It's a whole debate we could get into. We don't have time for.
We, alright. Oh, God. The primetime players backstage.
We should make time for this. As much as it doesn't deserve time, we should make a little time.
It deserves primetime.
Nice.
That was pretty good.
That was decent.
That wasn't bad, right?
It was alright.
All right. Dude, it seems like it's going to be a weekly thing. We saw it this week. We saw it the previous week.
Yeah, last week they dressed up and mocked the Ascension and the New Day.
Right.
This week it was Los Matadores.
Right.
And then there was the big gay rainbow, if you want to get into that, with Darren Young.
Talk about that, dude.
I'd like you to, because you got a very strong opinion. You did your Facebook post, and I'll back you up along the way, because I agree completely. And obviously I agree, because it's obvious what they're doing.
It's not that I have a strong opinion, but
not a strong opinion, but a definite, it's obvious what they're doing.
In the gay community, I don't know what the word I'm looking for, but the symbol or the logo, I don't know what I'm looking
their
for.
Their colors and yeah.
But the rainbow colors,
I think the significance in the fact that it's a rainbow color is that they all come together and make this big thing. Why can't we all come together, whether we're black, white, gay, straight,
I don't
Puerto
know
Rican,
what the meaning behind
I don't
the
either.
Rainbow
I
in the gay community
yeah,
is. I don't know what the meaning behind it is, but in the gay community,
because it's fabulous and it's pretty and beautiful, it goes with my shoes.
They wear.
Come on, it goes with my shoes.
If I've never been to one, but like gay pride parades, right, where people are going, you see a lot of rainbow colors and rainbow flags.
That's their
like
official
that.
Thing.
It's
yeah.
kind of a symbol of the gay community. So the fact that
I switched chairs, it's still squeaking. I'm
when,
sorry.
When ahead. Well, mine does too. They all squeak. No. The primetime players, they're cutting this promo last night, and they have Darren Young. You know, Titus O'Neil brings up rainbows for some reason, and Darren
there was
Young
a rainbow colored teddy bear or something.
All right, and Darren Young says,
"That's my favorite.
Oh, that's
color.
My favorite color.
Yeah,
rainbow's
yeah, yeah.
my favorite color." And of course, Darren Young, who recently came out a couple of years ago to TMZ,
yes.
came out and said that he was openly gay,
yes.
And WWE came out and supported him. But then they go on national television on Monday Night Raw, and very subtly, oh, my favorite color is rainbow.
I don't think that's
something
so
like
subtle,
that.
By the way.
It's not that, it's not subtle.
It's almost
but it's
in
not,
your face.
It's in your face, and Darren Young came out on Twitter and sent out a tweet last
yes.
night that says,
well, that's why I wanted you to do it, because you had that reaction on your feedback, your Facebook post, to where everybody thought you were overreacting, or they thought it was funny, or they thought, I'm gay and I completely go with it, and blah, blah,
it's
blah,
not,
blah.
I don't have any problem with gays.
Well, the
other
thing was,
like
Darren
that,
Young clearly seemed fine with it, so why are you upset? Darren Young did not seem fine with it based on the tweet that we read.
Right.
It almost seemed like, yeah, they asked me to do it. Alright, I'll do it. That didn't seem like he was jumping up and down. Yeah, I get to tell everybody my favorite color is rainbow, which isn't even a fucking color,
yeah.
by the way. It's a fucking symbolic thing about that community.
Yeah, it's,
I don't know what to call that community, but you can't say gay community.
It was a shot at Darren Young. They're basically, you know, I mean, it wasn't outrageous where like, wow, I can't believe they did that. It was just, you know, my favorite color is rainbow. So
classless.
It was classless, no doubt, but it wasn't this over.
It was
a clear shot at Darren Young for being gay. My favorite color is rainbow.
Yeah.
But It wasn't.
In that sense, it was
way overboard.
What we talked about, we've talked about it many times, but I think we broached the subject last week to where Vince McMahon and the main guys are called, they're so juvenile in their sense of humor. They love doing things.
They get a laugh off that. Yeah.
They love doing things that are like almost not private jokes because everybody got it. The rainbow is my favorite color.
Right.
Everybody knows Darren Young's gay if you're a real wrestling fan.
Right.
But it's just one of those where Vince and him get a good chuckle at it because
they're
such, they got
like
such
that.
Sophomore
right.
humor, and it's almost like hazing is what we were saying in college.
Right.
Like,
right.
let's razz the new guy. It's stupid. Didn't serve a purpose in the storyline. It was just a way of, you motherfucker.
We had Ryback defeated Luke Harper. This went 1 minute and 48 seconds.
Got a couple of
1 minute, 48 seconds. We had Dolph Ziggler defeated Neville. This went 2 minutes and 7 seconds.
No.
All right,
9 minutes and 7 seconds.
Oh, 9 minutes. This
they
was
gave
one
us
of longer
some time.
One.
They gave it a commercial.
So. You go up. You had...
you just skipped what
know,
I believe, right?
You had Damian Mizdow and The Miz. 2 minutes and 1 second. You had
so
Seth
you
Rollins
go.
Defeated Kane.
Four
minutes and 33
oh,
seconds.
Oh, there's
you
one
had
you
Stardust defeated Fandango. 1 minute and 7
there's
seconds.
Another
you had
skipped.
Dean Ambrose
yeah.
defeated Adam Rose. 2 minutes and 11
one
seconds.
More,
I mean,
think there was one more. And we'll just do the times. Dean Ambrose, all right, we'll go, we already
Randy
did
Randy Orton defeated Cesaro,
so Dean Ambrose, 18 Dean Ambrose defeated Adam Rose, 2 minutes, 11 seconds. Stardust
right.
defeated Fandango, 1 minute, 7 seconds. Why Stardust was squashing anybody, I have no idea. Seth Rollins defeated Kane, 4 minutes and 33, but that
already,
was an,
we just did all
that was an angle, but we're talking about the time.
All right.
Damian Mizdow defeated The Miz, 2 minutes, 1
minutes,
second.
1 second.
Ryback defeated Luke Harper, 1
minute,
48,
48
seconds.
Seconds.
And then we get into that one, which was 9:07, but then I think we get back down to some,
Well, the main event was, I mean, that was the main event. It was
oh,
until
the segment, yeah.
Rollins and J&J Security announced came out,
the,
right? They announced
stipulations.
The stipulations. So, number one, it's going to be no RKO allowed. That's Seth Rollins. He's in there. He's sitting in a recliner.
A lazy boy.
Laid
recliner.
Back. He's laughing. Ha, ha, ha. Randy Orton eventually comes out. He makes it. He says, well, I got a stipulation, too.
Yeah. Well, Randy Orton
match
said
earlier.
First, I think. Or no, it was it?
It was Rollins out there in the recliner.
I know he was out
his,
first, but
and
okay.
then Randy Orton came out and says, all right, no RKO.
Yeah, Gordon, but
well,
yeah, that
my
was
stipulation tip. Is I don't want the authority. I don't want J&J Security. I don't want anybody to interfere in this match.
Yeah, so
with that being said, we're going to put it in a cage. So
yeah.
no RKO, you get yours, I get mine,
yeah.
steel cage.
So the psychology behind it is, yeah, nobody's going to be able to, nobody on my side, if you're Seth Rollins, all
right,
nobody will be there to help you
right.
or help me.
Right.
But you can't do the one move that ends your matches to
right.
me.
Right.
I can do mine to you, curb stomp, but you can't do yours
you
to me.
You can't do it.
Which, by the way...
But the authority can't get involved.
Which,
so.
Which means they will.
Right.
Somewhere or another.
Right. All right, so...
Or Orton will do an RKO and get disqualified or some stupid bullshit. It'll be something...
Right. So, you ready?
Yes.
We have...
Let's mix some callers.
We have
We've
20
got
minutes to go.
Blowing up
we
right
got 20
now.
Minutes to go.
We phone can
lines
go along.
Are, phone lines are blowing up. So we'll take your live phone calls. If you guys want to call right now, you can do so. We only have one open phone line. So if you hear somebody on the line, just give it a
we
second.
We've
got to
get through these. There's a lot of calls, man.
Just
I haven't been telling you.
Just give it a second. And once we get somebody off the line, we'll have an open phone line and you guys can call up. So here we go. 5187.
And try and keep your questions brief because we gotta get to you and get off because we've got a lot of callers this week. So
518-712-3070. 518-712-3070. Caller, you're live on WZR TV. What's up?
Hey, what's going on, guys? How are you?
What's up, man?
All right, man. But I just think lately, like Monday Night Raw and stuff has been really, really lackluster and. It's like, I think this happens every year, like after WrestleMania, and then stuff starts getting a little better, I think, around July, when SummerSlam's coming up. But I wanted to get your guys' thought on this. Because Bray Wyatt has been, like, teasing all these promos and things, two things. Do you think there's a possibility that he could come out in Chicago and possibly maybe take a shot at CM Punk? Or, number two, he could just interfere in the cage match and set up a program with Randy Orton. What do you think?
As far as I mean, listen, dude, going into WrestleMania every year, I mean, that's the hot time, right? That's the hot period. It's WrestleMania, the build up, you know, Raw week after week, and not necessarily this year, although it was better than average. You're going into WrestleMania, so you're gonna have good Raws, you're gonna have good crowds, and you know it's WrestleMania. But every year, what he's saying is now that WrestleMania is over, you're back to the same old shit, man. You're back to the same old Raw week after week, man. So, and you're right, dude. It is back to just Raw week after week, and it's the same old shit. You know what I mean? But,
hello.
And then, hold you're on one second, Alan. Man. Hold on one second. And then, as far as Bray Wyatt, he's asking, you know, with a pay-per-view coming up in Chicago, would he do a subtle shot at CM Punk? I think they're well beyond CM Punk.
I don't think
they're
they
want to
acknowledge him, because then they get that gets the crowd chant started, the social media shit going. Yeah.
Especially in Chicago, if they acknowledge...
And because Punk's fighting in the next... I mean, he's supposedly fighting at the end of the year. Where, I mean, that's,
if they're in Chicago, they're not going to make any reference to CM Punk, because they know that crowd is going to jump all over that and chant. Caller, you're live on WZR TV. What's up? We'll call back.
Hello. It's Tosh from the chat. Yeah.
How you doing, man?
What's up, man?
The guy with... Yeah, all good. The guy with the T-shirt.
Oh, no doubt, no doubt. Did you get the T-shirt?
Yeah, man, I got it, man. I got it. Yeah, man. It's like,
hey,
it's been like 3 months, but it's here, man.
I got your email. No. Wait a minute. I got to apologize, and I got to apologize for two reasons, right? So this guy, I finally email, or not email, I finally mail out his T-shirt, right? And I said, send me an email. I said, send me an email when you get your T-shirt. So I get an email, and he says, hey, man, I got my T-shirt, but it smells like cigarette smoke like you wouldn't believe. I said, man, listen, I got to email you back. I was thinking about it before I came on here tonight. You know what it is, dude? They sit in boxes, and Boone can vouch for this, man. There are two boxes, giant boxes, huge, giant boxes that I have in my room, right?
I opened it, my girlfriend was like, what the fuck?
You got him in trouble. Did you start smoking blunts?
Listen, I got two giant boxes in my room, right? And I don't realize, because I smoke in the house, right? I don't realize that everything probably reeks of smoke in here, and I have no idea. And then I see people on Facebook, you know, and they say, I quit smoking, and I can't believe how much better that I smell.
Yeah.
I smell by, you know, now whenever I get in the car.
Yeah, when I used to live at home, my parents smoke, and my friends would be like, you smell like a fucking pub. What's going on? You reek. Like, what's this?
So now I got to know, every time before I mail out a T-shirt now, dude, I got to throw it in the washer before I mail it out. You know?
Don't they shrink it?
Yeah, man, make sure you get on that shit. Yeah, definitely.
I'll do that, man.
Anything else?
Hey, listen.
Yeah,
anything else before we let you go?
So basically, the guy before stole my question. I was going to ask about, you know, the quality.
All right, if you think of it, let us know, man.
Yesterday it was in fucking England, and I still couldn't stay awake. Like, what the fuck? You know, something's wrong. Something's definitely wrong. Like, it's bullshit, you know?
Yeah, no, I hear you, dude. Well, listen, I'm glad you got the T-shirt, man. And thanks for the support, dude. I'm sorry it took so long. And I know it's been forever and ever before you got that, but I'm glad you got it, and I'm going to email you back. I've got your email, so I'll shoot you an email ASAP. Call Jackie. Jackie! Hello?
Hi, boys.
Hello?
What's up, girl?
Oh, nothing much. I'm just happy.
Oh, my God. I'm so sorry. I accidentally clicked the button. I was going to move that out of the way. Jackie, please call back. That was my fault.
He lost Jackie of all callers. Listen, we're going to take all of your phone calls tonight. We got a lot of them. We got to stay late.
She's back.
I'm sorry, Jackie.
That was my fault.
Boone hung up on you.
It's okay. I was watching Raw last night, and I see Lana come out after Cena beats Barrett, and I wonder, where's Rusev? Oh, that's right. Rusev snuck up behind Cena and knocked him down over the chain. I'm happy that you 40 granted that match, because I'm trying to remember, when was the last time there was a chain match? Oh, that's right, back in 2001, Triple H versus Kane at Judgment Day.
She knows the date and everything.
Look
at
her. She does her
that girl
research.
Is a wrestling encyclopedia
before she calls
of knowledge.
Us, before she calls us, she Googles. She says, I know.
I think she just remembers this stuff.
I don't know. I think she
Googles. I really think she's got a trap brain with wrestling knowledge. I think she's very smart.
We love our Jackie, man. She is smart.
We do. Any questions on your mind this week,
well,
Jackie?
Let me ask you this. So we've got a Russian chain match going on at Extreme Rules. Does Rusev? I mean, listen, this is the third match between the two of them, right? We had What was the pay per view before WrestleMania?
It was
Payback.
Fastlane.
Fastlane. So we had Rusev won at Fastlane. We had John Cena win at WrestleMania 31. And now we've got the grudge match at Extreme Rules.
In
so,
Rusev's favor because it's a Russian chain match.
Russian chain match. So you know what, Jackie? I'm going to tell you right now. I think John Cena wins this. He comes out 2-1. Cena's up. It's Rusev's match. Like Boone said,
depending
it's
on
the
what
Russian
they're doing with Cena
match.
Going forward, but it really seems like they want to use him to try and elevate that U.S. belt.
I think Cena wins, Jackie. Yeah. What do you think?
I'm going with my guy and my girl. I'm going with them.
She's going with Rusev.
She's going with John Cena and Nikki Bella. Oh, she's going with Rusev and Lana. Okay,
Rusev
I got
and
mistaken.
Lana. All right. Now, keep in mind, Jackie, we put up on the website that John Cena has asked for a new United States title, which seems to indicate that John Cena's in for a fairly long U.S. title reign.
They're making him his own belt.
If they're making him his own belt,
and real quick,
he's in.
He's bringing back that spinner belt.
And he teased the spinner belt.
Oh, God.
So it seems to me that they're in, you know, John Cena.
Long haul.
You know, he's going to be a U.S. champion for the long haul. And if that's the case, Rusev's not winning at Extreme Rules. So I got to say Cena wins, Jackie. All right.
Let's see what happens first, because didn't Lana tease like a couple of months ago that the European title was coming back?
Yeah. We'll see. As of right now, there's no plans for the European title to come back, but we'll see what happens. Hey, Jackie, we got a lot of phone calls. Have a good week, all right?
Okay, and by the way, go Rangers. They're going to take out Pittsburgh, trust me, I know, because my boys are playing on Tampa Bay.
Oh,
Rangers?
Man.
I thought
the
you
Rangers.
Were Red Wings fans. What?
No.
I am. It's just that the Penguins have never been really my favorite hockey team because of a certain little incident after they won the Cup in 09 in Joe Louis.
All right.
Well, Jackie, we will look forward to hearing from you next week.
Hey, look for us on Raw next week, Jackie. Raw next week, Albany, New York. We're going to be there.
Try to get a picture of Rusev and Lana for me, okay?
Absolutely.
Thank you, Jackie.
Caller, you're live on WZR TV. What's up?
What's up, guys? It's Steven Grabig in the chat room.
Stevie.
How's it going, guys?
What's up with you, man? You let us know. What's up this week? You got a joke for us or a question?
Yes, I got a joke for you guys. Okay, what kind of bagel can fly?
What kind of pig what?
What kind of bagel can fly?
What kind of bagel can fly?
You got good hearing. What kind of bagel can fly?
I don't know. I got it.
We'll be wrong, so hurry up, please.
A bagel, an eagle. Something to do with an eagle, because bagel and eagle have...
No, you guys are way off. It's a plain bagel.
a plain bagel. Get it?
No butter,
bagel.
No cream cheese. Oh, God. That's fucking amazing,
applaud.
Bro. Yes.
Applaud the man.
Round of applause.
That's a good one.
We'll give you a round of applause.
For a Ryan Clark joke, that's a good one. And a Stevie Gervais joke, that's a good one.
What kind of bagel can fly?
Anything else
bagel.
On your mind, Stevie? We got a lot of calls to get to. If you got a question, let us know, man.
Oh, that's good.
No, that's about it, guys. All right, have a good week.
Hey,
right?
Keep the jokes coming.
What do you call a dog with two knees? Doesn't matter what you call, because it's not going to come anyway. Two knees, two legs.
He screwed up his joke.
Wait a minute. Before you let him go.
All right.
What do you call a fish with two knees? A toonie fish.
Oh, my God. Good
Lord. I agree.
All right, hey, sorry, guys. Just wanted to send a special shout-out to Dino in the chat room, all right?
Is he doing okay? Do you have an update on his condition?
No, he's doing all right. I'm just saying.
You're just giving
him
some props.
He's a good guy.
All right.
I just want to give him a shout-out.
All right. Up to Dino UK in the chat room, man. He's a good dude. All right. We got to get the rapid fire.
Yes, and the calls are going nuts here.
So all right, here we go.
And squeeze these back
we'll squeeze,
and forth.
Squeeze rapid fire in here. Mike Butler, with rumors of Bray Wyatt talking about Orton, where does Rollins go from their match if true possible Kane after last night? So basically,
you gotta read that again. I don't even know what the hell that means.
He's basically saying Bray Wyatt talking about Randy Orton. Where does Rollins go from their match? Okay, so you've got Randy Orton and Seth Rollins in a match.
Is Bray Wyatt talking about Randy Orton?
Is Bray Wyatt? Who is Bray Wyatt talking about? We don't know. Bray
Wyatt. Saying with rumors of Bray talking about Orton. Bray Wyatt. Where does Rollins go from their match, if true? Possible Kane.
There's no commas and things, so it's confusing.
Yeah, I have no idea what he's saying.
But basically, listen. Randy Orton and Seth Rollins. Randy Orton and Seth Rollins are about to face off, okay? We don't know who Bray Wyatt is talking about. So what happens,
he's saying Kane,
what happens after Rollins and Orton? What happens after their feud? Does Orton go on to face Bray Wyatt, or does Orton go on to face Kane with the authority whole thing? Kane possibly turn, if Kane turns babyface.
Oh, he's saying Rollins, Kane, if Kane turns babyface.
Right.
Yeah, but the way Rollins has been treating Kane, that makes perfect sense, although, my God, that's a shitty main event program.
Right.
But
right.
Then again, what are you going to do, man? They need some strong heels in the worst way right now.
We need to find out who's Bray is talking about first to find out where Bray's going.
We'll have to wait and see
what happens. Jason Hanson up
Jason
next.
Hanson and... Hanson and... Jason Hanson says, Anthony Pettis versus Miles Jersey. He asked for the pick. He also asked for a pick on Aldo versus McGregor. By the way, I love how they're having Neville face the top-tier talent and put him over on commentary. Thoughts on that? He is getting the reverse ascension treatment, even though, like, we were talking about this last night. All right, so he lost to Seth Rollins. But J&J Security was interfering. Rollins is the world
champion.
And Neville was a fighting, like, he wasn't getting squashed by any means. He was very competitive against the top champion in the company.
Right.
With the champion having help on the outside from J&J. He loses to Ziggler, but whatever. You know, he's in the top, in with the top guys.
But he keeps
losing. He holds his own. My only thing I can point to that this is good, this is good. But the only way it could be bad is if he becomes a new Curtis Axel. Because if you remember when Axel was first a Paul Heyman guy, he might not have been beating John Cena and even Triple H, I think. Maybe not Triple H. I think it was Cena, Triple H, like the top guys. He was with them and he would either win or it would be a draw or a no contest, and then where's Axel now? Axelmania, brother. Right. That's.
I don't think Neville has the look that WWE.
I don't think he's got the greatest future.
Hold off on the phone calls.
We'll leave him on hold while we get through.
David Hadley, do you think Neville is being used right now, going toe to toe with the stars? We'll get him over.
We can't do the MMA.
Better than the traditional. Yeah, answer the question. It's basically Neville. I mean, he's going head to head. Yeah, we're gonna go up. Neville's going head to head with top guys, so sure, it puts him in there with top guys, and they're giving him a decent amount of time in there with those top guys. But where does that lead in the long run? Although he's in there with top guys, he's not getting wins.
Okay.
He's losing every time. So what's going to happen from here? Does he turn into the next Curtis Axel, or do they put him in a feud with
somewhere in the middle. He won't be a serious thing, but I don't think he'll go as low as Axel. Not yet.
Right.
But does he settle into the Axel spot?
Right.
Maybe not the comedy version, but he'll be a lower mid-card.
Right.
High, main event on Superstars. Main event on main event.
UFC picks.
Yes, UFC picks. Jason Hanson had asked, real quick just to announce, UFC on Fox 15 is this Saturday.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, God, what's the main event?
Machida and Luke Rockhold.
Luke Rockhold, Leona Machida, also the two hottest chicks.
Yeah, two hot chicks fighting.
Felice Van...
Van Vliet.
Paige Van Zandt and Felice Herrig. It was going to be Jacare and Yoel Romero, but Yoel Romero got injured. That card kind of fell apart, too. Max Holloway and Cub Swanson.
It's good fights, dude, but the only main draw...
The main event is a very important fight. That was the previous. So he's talking about the UFC on Fox 16. Three big fights were announced. The main event will be Henan Burrell, TJ Dillashaw for the UFC Bantamweight Championship in that long-awaited rematch. And that'll be on Free Fox, so that's a pretty big one. Miles Jury, and you went away, so I forget the opponent already.
I'm just scrolling down. I'm trying.
Miles Jury and Anthony Pettis, the former UFC lightweight champion, will be the co-main.
Right.
Pettis should be able to handle that one. And then the third fight that they announced was another big one.
You got it here? Aldo and McGregor. All right,
that's the pay-per-view in July, 2 days after my birthday. Oh, it's a chick fight. It is Misha Tate and Jessica Eye.
Okay.
So those are the top three fights announced. Picks, I got Pettis over Jury. I've got, I got to say Burrell over Dillashaw. I think it was a fluke. And then I'll take Tate over I.
Anthony Remy
real
is...
Real quick, though. Rockhold, Machida, who you got?
Machida.
I'll go Rockhold.
But I
want Rockhold to win more than I think he's going to win.
Anthony Remy is Bad News Barrett retiring. I heard he was not sure if it was true or not. I'm not sure about that. Bad News Barrett?
Yeah, I don't think so.
Haven't heard about it.
I think he teased it in an angle.
No, I think
he teased it in an angle at the house shows.
Yeah.
I think the European tour this past weekend, I think a big angle they were doing was that he was calling out Conor McGregor, like all the Irish star, and then I think he got injured or something.
Yeah, I love how
you point to the clock when you want to run. When I'm saying let's get through the callers.
I've been doing it for the last five.
The callers talk. Motherfucker. Where are we at? It's your
Matt time. Johnson. I just did the last one.
Okay.
Man.
Thought Raw was a solid show last night. As for Tough Enough, who do you think will be the contestants? Could it be the recently signed talent like Uha Nation? Is that how you say that? Uha Nation?
Uha Nation.
Okay, it's 11 NXT rookies. I mean, we heard the rumors that the Tough Enough, at least that was the plan at one point, that the new season of Tough Enough wasn't going to be a bunch of nobodies that's never wrestled trying to become a wrestler. It was going to be indie guys or like some of the lower level NXT guys competing to win the show. So it could be, I don't know about
Uha
Nation.
Could be the rookie class that they announced. I
don't know about Uha Nation.
Yeah.
But you never know. Maybe if they want to make the show something, that's one way to do it.
Nick D, after the UK tour is over, do you see any WWE superstars being released like they normally do in previous years? You know what? I was thinking about it the other day. Spring cuts probably coming up. We'll see. We'll see if there's cuts. They didn't do it last year.
Brandon Brown says, what did you think about Finn Balor posting that tweet of him on, that's a good question, on Raw's London set? I know it has been done to death, but with NXT being so popular and saying future is now, do you guys see an NXT invasion angle possible? Anything's possible. A full-off invasion, I do not see, because that would kind of screw up NXT, because then who do they got left if they take all their top guys and a big angle for the main roster?
Right.
Even though they got these new rookies,
the tweet was interesting with Finn Balor on the phone booth yesterday.
It really seemed like he was debuting.
It did. It did.
But he didn't.
So. Vincent Nugent, how in the blue hell are WWE going to deliver and perform that Kiss My Arse match at Extreme Rules 2015 between Ziggler? Thoughts on the boys? I think Ziggler kisses his ass.
Boone
thinks maybe they go a different,
yeah.
Whatever it may be, a false finish or something.
I mean,
like
the
that.
Correct answer is who gives a shit. But, yeah, I don't think it'll happen. Jason Hansen, thoughts on the past jobbers past jobbers filing a lawsuit against WWE saying they were injured, etc., when in reality, they also wrestled in many other countries and took more punishment there, etc. In my opinion, it's bullshit and it'll get thrown out quick.
It is BS. I think it's lawyers that are coming on to ex-talent saying you can make a lot of money off WWE.
They'll settle, you'll get money no matter what.
I don't think they settle. I think WWE fights it.
I think they fight it. I think they fight it so much that the people can't keep up financially and they just, you know.
I think it's lawyers trying to make money off ex-talents. Even if the lawyer says,
I think it's the opposite. I think it's ex-talents trying to make money assuming that they'll just get paid to shut up.
I think I'm trying to make this as quick as possible, but I think lawyers are contacting the ex-talents and they're saying you can make money off WWE. Knowing that they really don't have a case, right? We agree on that. They don't have a case. They don't have a case, dude.
They have a case, but a case that, like he said, you can't prove you got those injuries in WWE. A lot of these guys played football. A lot of these guys wrestled years and years before being in WWE.
Right. So
how
can
you prove the concussion
stuff?
Right. That happened here.
Right.
And if it did happen here, they didn't help us with treatment.
I think the lawyers say, all right, you don't have to pay us fees unless we win the case, but there's still fees involved, dude. You're going to have to pay the lawyer eventually.
I think they think if you get enough former names all joined together on a class action lawsuit,
it's separate lawsuits, dude.
But
these
if they join together in a class action, that's a big fucking thing to fight. So
it'll be interesting.
And I don't know a lot about
the
legal
system. All thrown out of court.
I don't know a lot about legalities and in the judicial system. Is that even the right
judicial word?
That's right. How little I know. But I would seem to think that it's not. I don't know.
They're not going anywhere. None of these lawsuits are going anywhere.
Joseph Gallo, Kali returning to WWE.
WWE denied the rumors, right?
Khali straight up said yes.
I'm coming back.
WWE sent out a statement.
Straight up said no.
They said no.
Khali straight up said yes. WWE
put it this
straight
way,
up said
if they
no.
ever plan on touring India anytime soon,
he'll make a guest appearance or something like
he'll
that.
He'll either get re-signed for that and then very right. sporadic work or, yeah, make an appearance.
One more from Joseph Gallo.
What is the deal with Daniel Bryan? With Daniel Bryan
health issues. I put that up on the website today. I don't know if you
it's
saw it or not.
It's a big deal, yeah.
But,
no, I'll let you take it.
There are reports that he's in rough shape. I know that Daniel Bryan's got a match at the Extreme Rules pay-per-view, so they are going to have him continue to wrestle. But they did keep him pretty much out
of
the
ring. Who's
he
working? I'm sorry, because this is kind of relevant.
It's Daniel Bryan and Bad News Barrett.
That's a rough guy to be working
that
with.
Is a rough
Unless
guy.
Unless he's
going
to take care of
that
him
is
on
a rough
purpose.
Guy. Yeah. Right, yeah. We'll see what happens, but they've kept him out of action pretty much. I mean, not a heavy workload on Raw the last couple of weeks, so there are reports that he's in pretty rough
that
shape.
That one's kind of an interesting one that you're good.
David Hadley?
Yeah, I'll let you take it.
Regarding a UK European WrestleMania,
yeah.
Do you think if it were to happen one day, it would be shown on pay-per-view / WWE Network in the United States in the afternoon, started at 7 p.m. in London, it would start at 3 p.m. Eastern Time noon over on the West Coast in the States, be sort of like watching Sunday Night Football, or Sunday Football, 3
p.m.
or NASCAR.
Eastern, noon in the West
That's
Coast.
A good point, where we would watch it during the afternoon hours, but the United Kingdom, they would be able to do it 7, 8 o'clock over there. It's a good point that he brings up, but
with the
watching a
cost,
WWE pay-per-view in the United States at
breaking
1
that
o'clock.
Habit, the production cost,
yeah.
There's a lot of issues that I
not only that, but
that'd
we
be
know,
a whole show trying
we
to
know that,
that
32, 33, and 34 is going to be in the United States as well, so it's going to be...
It'll be years before that's even
years
a possibility, and there's a billion times they wanted to bring SummerSlam back, because Wembley Stadium, for the longest time, they said WrestleMania 3 was the largest attendance, 93,000.
Right.
It actually was like 73,000, but they lied and said 93,000, that's what
right.
they do.
Right.
The Wembley Stadium, SummerSlam in 92, did a legitimate, and don't quote me on this number because I always forget it, but it was either high 70s or like 82,000, so it didn't beat the 93,000 that WrestleMania 3 did.
Right.
But it was a...
It was up there.
It was not the most, like, perfect number, but it was way more legitimate than
right.
what they claimed for WrestleMania 3. So for the longest time, the London SummerSlam pay-per-view was the largest attendance WWE ever had.
Okay.
Now, they've beaten it since, but, yeah.
Allie.
I don't know where we're at.
Allie
Adair. Hey, Hans Brolo. Cheers for the shirt. That's for you, man.
Cheers for the shirt. Fits like glove, although I smell like an ashtray wearing it.
Yeah,
you ever think
call?
The ratings will drop? Yes, as the product continues to decline. Your show is how I keep up and find myself switching off at about hour two, even last night that they were in the fucking UK. So he's from the United Kingdom. I sent the shirt out there. But, yeah, I mean, listen, if the product's not good, the ratings are probably going to drop, man. There were times 10 years ago where we were doing 6.0, 7.0 ratings. Right now they're down to 2.8, 2.9, 3.0. So it's pretty bad, man.
Nugent and Matt Johns, and they just can't do it. But, all right, let's read them.
They can't do it.
Have you guys heard the rumors, spelled in the UK version, so if he is a body, he's a UK body.
I would read the first line and that's it.
Yeah.
I'd cut it off there.
Okay. I haven't skimmed it, but alright. Have you guys heard the rumors about TNA Wrestling paying their talents late?
Matt
Hardy took to his social media outlets and addressed the rumors along with him on Twitter, tweeting of checks he has with TNA. Your thoughts on this, guys? We already
talked about it earlier, man. Yeah. Talked about it earlier.
Why'd you make me read it?
I didn't know what he was saying. I didn't read
okay.
it. Or, hey, Romero, has WWE given up or gave up on Roman as the next guy, or will they rebuild him with a mid-card title? It seems to me like after Raw last night, they're still going Roman.
Well, maybe, but the mid-card titles are clearly, in my opinion, staying on Cena for a while and Daniel Bryan for a while. So he said rebuild him with a mid-card title? Probably not. Is he still... He's still their pet project.
I think so.
But it is early, and maybe they think, all right, let's give him some time, and he'll reconnect with the fans, and it'll work.
There you go.
Vincent Nugent says, Ryan and Matt, you guys missed the last week, you guys missed this last week regarding about the return of, God, you need to learn how to write, the return of WWE Tough Enough for its sixth season, but the date that he will be premiering on the USA Network, who is he? The date that will be premiering on the USA Network on Tuesday, June 23rd, 2015 at 8 p.m. Eastern Time. Hope it helps, boys.
Yeah, we put that up on the website last week. They revealed via press release that it was going to debut on the USA Network on Tuesday, June 23rd at 8 p.m. Eastern Time. Who's going to be on the show? We don't know yet. There's
Jericho's,
a big announcement by Triple H next week on Raw from
Jericho's
Albany,
rumored to be the host, but I still can't believe they're not putting that show on the WWE Network. I just can't believe it. Legends House was one of the best things they did. I thought Legends House sucked.
They're doing
Tough Enough fun.
They're doing Tough Enough on the USA Network, but also on Raw, for the last 2 weeks, we've seen about 7 different shows that have been plugged. I know there's 11 total.
For the network.
But, for the network. Two hot for
Springer,
TV.
Come.
But they're plugging the shit out of them on
come
Raw
on,
every single
Tough
week.
Tough Enough?
And look. We haven't seen new content on the network for forever.
Okay.
We've seen Attitude Era content, things like that. This is new, original content.
You say that.
Added to the network, and I think it's a good thing.
You didn't watch the Monday Night War series.
I didn't.
WWE Rivalry series. You didn't watch. I could go on forever.
Those are DVDs,
Rewind.
Man.
A lot of them were
DVDs.
None of what I just said were DVDs.
The Monday Night Wars?
The Monday Night War was a 16-episode series that has never been on a DVD anywhere.
All right.
The the rivalries thing. Never been on a DVD anywhere.
All right.
WrestleMania Rewind, never been on a DVD anywhere. These are some of the best shows they've ever done.
Fact.
WWE 24, that new series, they've only done 2 episodes of it, then they stopped. One was a detailed backstage look at WrestleMania 30. The other one was Booker T's Sentence to Greatness, whatever the fuck, the jail thing.
Right.
Those were good shows, and you didn't care about them to watch enough. You're gonna watch Jerry Springer and a Seth Green cartoon about wrestling. You're not watching that shit.
I think Too Hot for TV.
But Tough Enough you would watch, wouldn't you?
Absolutely.
Are you gonna watch the cartoon with Seth Green?
Not the cartoon. I'm not a fan.
You're
of
gonna
cartoons.
Watch one episode of the Jerry Springer thing, and you're gonna turn it off.
Probably.
Because Rachel Ray will be on at the same time.
Probably.
And you're gonna say, "Ah, fuck that."
But. In the long run,
I had to do it, man.
USA Network, they do need. I know they need to make money for the network. They also need to make
USA Network
happy as well. Even though
you don't
got,
think they're making them happy,
they've already got Raw and SmackDown. So
yeah. They just
here.
Re-signed right. Raw for multi years. They got SmackDown. They got the Hall of Fame every year. I mean,
I know 3 more.
All right, is it up to me here?
Yep.
David Hadley says, "What kind of jackass gets off on seeing someone kiss someone's ass?"
Vince McMahon, bro. Vince McMahon.
I can't add anything to that.
Vincent Nugent, did you guys watch the 2015 Masters? I did. I watched on Sunday. I didn't watch Thursday, Friday, or Saturday. I watched on Sunday. I watched the entire end. I watched from about...
Is it a dominatrix convention?
4 o'clock until about 7 o'clock when it ended.
The Masters.
And Spieles. Won it all.
Spieles.
He set all sorts of records.
Was that the one you were telling me about? The Baba Booey, this and that?
No, there's always a guy in golf tournaments. He yells, Baba Booey!
What was that? Because you said it was obnoxious on one of them.
What happens every
recently,
year?
Though.
Yeah, it was at the Masters. It's at every golf tournament.
Okay,
the guy
just
yelled,
the other day, you were like, yo, it was even worse than usual.
Oh, he yelled something like, I love beef, or something like that. And I was like, what are you doing? Yeah. What are you talking about? But I watched the Masters on Sunday. I watched the end of it. I watched the post-interview where he went into the clubhouse.
Here's his follow-up. And if so, what were your thoughts on Jordan Spieth?
Spiel.
Winning the tournament and making history as well.
He's a young cat. He's a good dude.
Is he the youngest guy ever to do it?
Him and Tiger Woods are tied for the course record all time at the Masters.
So is that the history he made?
No, he made other history. Well, for round one or round two, one of the rounds, he set the all-time course record. I know. We're talking about the Masters, so
wow.
You keep asking
very
me questions,
important.
Follow-up questions.
You would too, and then, hurry up with your answer.
Let's go.
All right. Last one.
Masters was good.
Nick D, what do you think that the rough WWE Network subscriber number is now seeing?
Well, they just announced it a week ago.
Hold on, let me read that again. What do you think that the rough WWE Network subscriber number is now seeing that WrestleMania is over? What does he mean?
He wants to know what the number for
What is it now that WrestleMania is done?
The night after WrestleMania? I don't know if you missed it on the websites, but they announced 1.3 million network subscribers. That's what they came out and announced the night after WrestleMania. So you must not have seen that post.
Well, I think his question is, now that WrestleMania is over, what do we think the number is?
They announced it the day after WrestleMania.
I know, but I think he's saying, now that that's over, what will it... I think he means to say, what will it be now that the rest... Now that everybody signed up for Mania, and that got us to 1.3, what is it going to be now that they've got nothing big to sign up for?
Oh, after WrestleMania? I mean,
first of all, we've got a month of 1.3, because that's the 30-day subscription. But after that, your guess is as good as any, but who the fuck knows? I mean... They've got this month for free, right?
Jerichoholic, what are you talking... I got your question. Jerichoholic, what are you talking about? I don't care about any. I care about all of you guys. Now that...
I don't have reading difficulties.
1.3 million after WrestleMania, I get what he's asking. What you're saying is, now that WrestleMania is over and we have 1.3... We've got Extreme Rules coming up.
But this
what
month's free.
What are we going to... And this month's free.
So I think his question is...
Where are we going to go from here?
Yeah, my interpretation was, when everybody that signed up just for Mania, and that got us that big 1.3 number, now that they have their WrestleMania gone and behind them, once their subscription expires,
right,
what will the new number be? But it's hard to say, because now we immediately, for April, the very next month, right now, we've got a free month, and that traditionally, the last two times they've done it, has bumped the number. But because we're coming fresh off of Mania, where you get an unusual extra amount of sign-ups, how many people are like, well, Mania's done, I'm not re-signing, but oh, it's free, so I'll stay, or more people will come because it's free. Like, when the smoke clears and the April free month is over, what would your guess be for the number? And I know we won't find out until the third quarter, second quarter.
1.4 max.
You think it's going to go up?
It may go down because, I think a lot of people signed up for WrestleMania, so they've got a six-month subscription.
Right, you can do month-to-month now.
Oh, that's right.
Which, by the way, blows my mind.
1.4 max.
That means you could spend that. Last year, if you wanted Mania, you could get it for $10 technically, but you had to spend $60, and then part of your $10 per pay-per-view was Mania being one of them. But you also had to spend $60. Now you can spend $10, get your Mania, no longer resubscribe, and move on about your business.
What do you think?
So WrestleMania is almost literally $10 now, because you don't need to spend $60 to see it. Mm-hmm. You can spend $10 just for the month of WrestleMania. Fuck that, I'm not re-signing afterwards. What do I think? I think that's a whole show we need to spend time on, and I don't even want to get into it right now.
No, but wait a minute. I said they're at 1.3
now. I
couldn't
even guess.
They're at 1.3 now.
Because of the fact that they went straight from Mania, where you're going to get all those extra sign-ups, their thought process, I can tell you, at least from my opinion, is we get all these extra sign-ups for Mania, and then immediately after Mania, when they think everybody's going to stop and not and cancel their 1 month, because they can do 1 month, they're
going
to cancel it. Oh, now we'll get it to re-sign, because A,
and then
it's a
they
free
announce
month.
All these new shows.
A, it's a free month, so why not stay around another month? And right. Then, oh, we get all these free new shows, too. So let's stick around for that month, too. I think it's going to drop.
Drop.
But we won't know until the... Is it the second... What month are we in?
It's going to be
It'll be the second quarter conference call.
It'll be the first quarter conference call going into the second quarter. They announced it yesterday.
No, the next time we hear a new number, it's at each conference call.
It'll be for the first quarter.
No, the first quarter is of January to March.
January, February, March.
Yeah, we already got that. So the next time we hear a number will be the second quarter conference call, which would be April, May, it'll be June, right? January, February, March, we've already heard that number, 1.3.
Yeah, they did that the day after WrestleMania.
And that was the first quarter. So the next time we get a number...
They've got to come out and report their first quarter numbers, all the financials, all the... They haven't done that yet.
Who do you think the one in March was?
That was for the fourth quarter of last year.
No, because that was the number for including WrestleMania.
The day after WrestleMania, all they announced was the network numbers. They didn't do the financials. They didn't
I'm
do
not
the
talking
home
about
video.
That. I'm talking about the subscriber count.
They have not revealed the first quarter numbers.
Yes.
They have not revealed yet. For January, February, and March, we're just into April.
Yeah.
So for January, February, and March of this year, mm-hmm. they're still tallying that stuff up. We're only 13 days into April. So when their first quarter conference call comes up, which is probably going to be the end, we reported the exact date yesterday, WWE to reveal their first quarter numbers on, if you guys can find it for me, it's probably going to be the end of April or first week of May, they're going to report the first quarter numbers. Now, for April, May, and June, the second quarter, they're going to report that come July. Same thing. with it, it goes, and then when we get into January of next year, they'll report the fourth quarter numbers from 2015.
Okay.
We don't have the fourth. We don't have the first quarter
so
numbers.
So we don't know how many people signed up for Mania.
No, the day after WrestleMania, the day after the Monday after WrestleMania, Vince McMahon and what's his name, George Berrios, held a conference call, and all they revealed was the network number. That's all they revealed. They didn't reveal the home video.
I'm not asking about any.
They didn't reveal the shop
about the network number.
We know the network numbers
up
after WrestleMania.
When? All right, so up till WrestleMania, which was last month.
Right.
The last month of the first quarter.
Right.
So my question is not all these financial things. My question is, what will the network number be in the second quarter?
In the second quarter, we're going to have to wait until July to find that out.
That's exactly what I just said.
They're going to have to wait until July. But for everything else, as far as the first quarter...
I don't care about that.
You asked about the first quarter earnings.
No. I asked about the network subscriber count, and I said, when do we find out?
Well, the first quarter earnings, everything combined, we're not going to find out for another month or so. Yeah. When they tally everything
I don't care about how many t-shirts they sold. I'm just curious about the network number.
That's a Tuesday night, brother.
Is that Tuesday?
That's a Tuesday night.
All right, man.
We're out of here. Get some sleep tonight, brother.
I'm going to. Believe
I need
me.
Some sleep, too, man.
I'll sleep like a baby.
All right. We will see you guys next Tuesday.
And gals.
And gals. And gals. We've got a couple gals in here.
If there's any transvestites or weird halvesies or anything, hey, we'll see you guys, too.
Your favorite color's rainbow?
Hey.
Hey.
So it's Vince's too. He had such a good time laughing
it's
at that.
It's Darren Young's too.
He had such a good time laughing at that. You fucking sick old
you
bet.
Sick old fuck. Anyways, we're out of here. We will see you guys next Tuesday night.
You're damn right we will.
8:10 Eastern time. Are we going to go out with that? We started from the bottom.
I'm
going to
do Vince because we just make fun of him.
I like that. Yeah. All right, we're out of here.
It's
going to
be a surprise.
Tuesday night. 8:10 Eastern time. WZRonline.com. Matt Boone and I are going to Monday Night Raw, Albany, New York.
I'm not, but he's taking his nephew. He better at least.
He's going to Raw with me next week.
Who's
going to
do play-by-play?
None of us. We're taking the night off.
Asshole,
we don't get a night off.
My boss is going to say, all right, don't worry about it.
For one night.
All right, well, then we got to take a hit financially because I get paid a lot of money to do
we'll
that.
We'll take a hit financially.
If you say that, then
365 days a year, we work our fucking asses down here.
He
we
said it on air. Now,
we
if
can
it doesn't
take
happen,
one night off and attend Monday Night Raw when it's on our home city. We're out of here.
I've never been to a Raw. You know that, right?
A live Raw?
Never.
Next Monday.
Only time I've been to a WWE TV was with you at a SmackDown in Albany. And that was... What are we going to run for right now? Yeah, the only TV... I've been to a Nitro.
Yeah.
And this was back during the Monday Night Wars. My godfather...
In Baltimore, right?
In Baltimore, my godfather won a radio contest. I was there the night after the biggest Starrcade they ever did.
Really?
Was it the biggest Starrcade? It was the Hogan-Sting Starrcade, that year-long build-up where Sting was in the rafters.
Right.
And they finally did the Hogan defending the title against Sting, and we don't know if Sting's NWO or not because he wears black and white.
Right.
After being colorful all those years,
right.
He would come down with a bat, and then we figured out he's on WWE set. Long story short, I was there the next night at Nitro.
I can top
it
that.
It was a historic night, too, because Jericho did
I can top that.
Slamming a chair thing. He turned heel. Hogan, if I'm not mistaken, look it up. I swear I feel like I'm wrong, but I swear this is what I remember seeing. Hogan finally drops the title to Sting at Starrcade. Oh,
right.
My God, the NWO is no longer in power. WCW wins the title back. They're hoisting Sting up on his shoulders. And then the very next night, Hogan won the title back.
Really?
That's how I remember it. Now,
and you were there for that.
I was there. But I've got an awful memory, and I was very young at the time. I had to be 12, 13 years old.
We're going to end it on this. I can top that.
But, yeah, real quick, I've only been to one TV for WWE. That was SmackDown with you.
You're right, right.
Never been to Raw, never been to a WWE pay-per-view, never been to a WCW pay-per-view.
We're going to Raw next Monday,
we'll
and
see.
I can top
we'll see.
Your whole post-Starrcade Nitro.
Oh, dude, I know you can.
Ryan Clark.
Beer truck.
Ryan Clark, Stone Cold Steve Austin, drove a beer truck into the arena.
Heyman
and
threw the hand at Vince.
Rock,
a different show.
Vince, Shane McMahon in the ring. Ryan Clark, fourth row. I was there. Albany, New
how
York.
About during the
Austin beer
how
truck.
How about during the invasion? Don't spill it on. How about during the invasion when Heyman, damn you, and threw his hat at Vince and shot on him?
Second row. First row.
Yeah.
First row.
You are on the,
View the video. View the video. I'll put it up on Facebook when we go off the air. I'm front row.
We've got
Heyman,
pictures of
Vince
you.
Vince McMahon shooting Heyman takes his hat, throws it off.
I get the hiccups just...
Yeah.
There was a on the Mr. McMahon WWE DVD, you're pictured in the crowd. We've got photos of you on your face.
I'm there.
Which one was that? Something big happened there, too.
Dude, they crashed the car. We're out of here.
Piss me off.
You got hiccups? Ah,
I gotta end the show.
All right, we're out of here.
Four.
See you guys.
That's me.
Eastern time. WZRonline.com. Motherfucking.com.
Feedback.
Submit your feedback. We want your feedback.
You gotta do it.
You can submit feedback by going to Facebook.com/MattBoomWZR, Facebook.com/RyanClarkWZR. We want your feedback. What can we do to improve? What can we do to do better? What did we do bad tonight? I don't know. Just go to Facebook.com/RyanClarkWZR, Facebook.com/MattBoomWZR.
What'd you like? We do more of it. What didn't you like? We do less of it.
We do more of it anyways. We want your feedback. Facebook.com/MattBoomWZR, Facebook.com/RyanClarkWZR. For Matt Boone.
That's me.
This is Ryan Clark. See you next Tuesday night, 8 to 10 Eastern Time, WZRonline.com. Take that hat off. Oh.